master.
We're back with the Opie and Anthony program. I'm so happy to see that Pal Talk is agreeing with what I'm about to say on the show.
Yes, Pal Talk gets a little advanced info.
I keep forgetting about that. We got the Mike's Pal Talk on. Cameras, in studio. People are checking us out all over the country through the Pal Talk. And they get to listen to what we're talking about as you guys are listening to promos and commercials and shit.
I think this is the only radio show in the country where you have the potential of listening in on what goes on during the breaks. Like even MSNBC, I guess, that's what Imus is on.
Yeah.
You can see during the commercial break sometimes, but they turn the sound off.
Right.
You're not listening in. This show, you can hear the crap we're saying when the mics aren't on.
And we say the real shit.
Sometimes, yeah, sometimes I forget to turn the mic off on during sensitive material. And
there are times I'm like, Anthony, please tell me the Pal Talk audio was down.
There are times we do have to shut it off if we're talking about business matters
right.
That, you know, that's what I want to do. I want to give 1,000 people insider information
right.
On the stock or something.
Well, what we
go to jail.
What we were discussing during the break, that guy, Mike from D.C., was kind of a buzzkill, and I'll tell you why.
Mike was a cock.
Sean White was here, the Flying Tomato. He won gold in Torino. It was just exciting to have him on the show.
And let me tell you, and I'll be totally honest, cool guy.
Very cool guy. We
like,
were hanging.
Cool.
I thought it was a fun interview, you know.
Yep.
Is it one of those interviews like, oh, my God, you're not going to believe what Opie and Anthony did today. No, but it was just a cool hang,
that
you know.
That was fun.
His people that came with him and publicists and said it was the best interview he has done, and he's interviewed with everybody. They said we did a better job than the Today Show and Bob Costas and the rest of them.
Because there's no pressure.
And then Mike
just
is
sit
like,
down and talk.
And then Mike is trying to, you know, blow up our spot saying, oh, yeah, the tough questions. We're just hanging with the guy. It was cool.
We were supposed to go over there, grab his medal. Opie was supposed to beforehand heat up a cauldron behind him, and then because Opie likes to break things, so heat up a cauldron and then throw it in and melt his medal down so we could all laugh at him and then throw the molten gold in his face.
We like to do the unexpected.
What an ass.
We like to do the unexpected at times.
Yeah.
But also at times, we just want to do the hang.
You can't shit on a gold medalist for no reason. It's stupid.
Mm-hmm.
Why would you?
You know, we have this reputation that you sit in the seat and come in here, we just beat the shit out of you. That's not true. There are people that deserve that treatment, and yes, we'll go down that road.
G. Gordon Liddy's another person who sat there. He wasn't ripped apart. We had a lot of fun with him for how much fun you could have with G. Gordon Liddy and not get shot. But that went very well. A lot of people emailed and said it was a really good interview. But some people are just like, dude, you know, you should have. You know, they're giving us advice on how we should interview these people.
Or Dick Cavett when he was here.
Right.
We had trashed Dick Cavett.
Dick Cavett,
fucking,
a legend. The interviews he's done, the people he's met. That's what I wanted to know about.
Right.
And that's what we talked about.
We're finally turning this thing around. I mean, no one wanted to come on our show because of our past reputation.
Yep.
You know, we'll still be dicks when we have to be. Yes, of course.
If a Steve the Whistler sits in that chair, you will get the host being assholes to this guy.
One man Star Wars guy.
Come on.
Sean White's not one man Star Wars guy.
If Sean White would have walked in here with some kind of attitude and given one word answers and, you know, been a dick or something, you'd have seen maybe us be a little more a little less cordial.
Yeah, but
no, the guy was great, a lot of fun, had some cool stories. The German fucking watching him piss story, very funny. It conjured up an image.
Yeah.
Take a knee, you Nazi, and look at that redhead's cock.
And they told me on the way out that you know, they were supposed to do Stern, and now they're blowing off Stern because they got what they wanted here.
There you go.
They really enjoyed
more listeners,
their time,
by the way, over here anyway. So
right.
Yeah, the guy's got a gold medal. It's not like he has a disease of the mind.
Well,
yeah,
this is it.
Gold medal winner.
I'll sum it up. We can't just shit on everybody. We can't do it. Because then no one will come on this show.
And I ask good questions. I was like, so what was that like?
That was riveting.
That was a good
one. To give people...
Jimmy, were you even in the room?
Dude, I don't fake it. I know nothing about snowboarding.
So, you're over there in Italy?
Yeah. Do you have any pizza or whatever?
I was literally out there going, is Jim in today?
As Alex Rieger once said, better to remain silent and be thought the fool than speak and remove all doubt. Eric Krieger said that. I didn't know about it. You two are doing a great job. I had one thought. If I wanted to chime in, I chimed in. Mm-hmm. My march line didn't get what it deserved as I smashed.
Wow. Let me tell you.
I have complete faith in that line.
I looked over and wanted to choke you.
Why? That wasn't a bad one.
It wasn't?
No.
It only goes up to March.
Because you were talking about hot chicks and curling calendar, and I said it only goes to March. I was saying that there were only three of them.
Okay. I don't think there was enough info in there to get the joke.
Okay. Well, it actually was, but it was just...
A little too smart. You were a little too smart.
Yeah,
what do you think I meant?
Like, what do you think I meant? It's just a nutty three-month calendar, you.
I was trying to... I don't know. I was thinking of when the weather got warmer.
No.
I know now, no.
What kind of goose would I be?
I was silly, okay.
No, because the chicks were hot or something.
Well, look at how hot this chick is.
Exactly.
Holy shit. It's Dee Dee.
Oh, my God. It's Anthony Michael Hall.
Right.
I thought it was Chastity Bono.
This is the girl curling competition.
Well,
they missed the fucking thing.
What do you expect?
They stunk. They missed the other rock. They didn't knock it out. It went straight through the target.
They weren't able to curl it enough.
How do you win this?
It's kind of like marbles. It's kind of like horseshoes. The scoring's like horseshoes, basically. Hey, man.
Let me do this for Jim. The backwards car crash for your joke.
Manny, what's up?
Took it back.
Hey, I just want to tell everybody that you guys are being a bunch of sensitive bitches this morning.
No, we're not.
We are not.
Bear in Maryland.
We're not at all, dude. We're just talking about how we feel, and I happen to feel fat and unattractive.
I'm bloated. I'm retaining water.
So you know what happens when guys are in a room for so many months on end like this, our periods all sync up. So we're a little sensitive today.
All right. Bear in Maryland, what's up?
What's Bear. Going on, boys?
Hey.
Bear.
Hi, sweet Jimmy.
Hi.
Hey, I just wanted to bring some... You must have a whole lot of new listeners with the Howie map and everything, because people don't realize that the Flying Tomato is not a serious questions-only candidate.
Right.
Oh.
I mean, this is someone you just want to hang out with and be cool. You guys aren't, you know...
And we also can tell when someone...
crying out loud.
We can also tell when someone comes in here and if they're going to call it in or if they're going to have fun. That guy really enjoyed his time on the show. It was a good hang. He was supposed to be here 10 minutes. He was here, I think it was close to 40 minutes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. He was loving you guys, man. I mean, that's what it's all about. Chilling out, hanging with the stars, man.
I mean, if there was...
Old metal, are you kidding me? What are you going to ask him about conditions of the third world country? Give me a break.
There you go. Thanks, Bear.
I'm punching out.
All right. Enough. We got to move on here. Dave in San Diego. Dave.
Hey, what's up, boys?
Hey.
Dave.
Hey, Jimmy, you did ask the tough questions. You asked them what a 1200 was, and they had to count on their fingers to figure it out.
360.
Oh, yeah.
6, 7, 20, 9
into
7, 8, 9, 10, 1080.
It still didn't make sense, though. Or did it?
Well, 1080.
1080 and then?
And then another.
120.
120. See, but it's a 12 and change, I think.
Yeah, maybe it's not exact math. I just didn't know what it meant. I don't know anything about it.
Three and a half times around or something?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Maybe it's like just three and a quarter or whatever
12.
It would be. Or
what?
Three and a third, right? Mm. Three and a... I don't know.
I think you need a half or a fully to fall down.
It's got to...
Yeah, you got a quarter. You land
can't
sideways.
You can't land on a quarter. Yeah. That doesn't work.
I thought of a stupid thing I should have said to make myself sound young. I didn't think of it.
What would that be?
I was talking about this girl. I said, she was babalicious.
Wow.
All the young guys.
Kids are using that word now.
Yeah. Hey, before we see what Bill Burr's been up to, we gotta say hi to Dugout Doug. He's been on hold for a long time here. Doug, what's
not
up?
Not just here.
Oh, it's no problem at all. Yeah, we've been working since about 6 o'clock this morning.
Yep. How goes it?
What the fuck do these people pay $12 a fucking month for? This show that he puts on is fucking ridiculous.
Oh, Howie's show?
Not even ours.
You don't understand. 10 minutes into the show, they play the fucking Wake Up, White People. That's from fucking 20 years ago, isn't it? The fucking Would Ye. Oh, douchebag says what? Are you fucking kidding me? You're still fucking doing that?
Doug gets agitated.
Holy shit.
the ONA pests, they're going after Howard now, and they're not happy about it because they have to sit around and listen to that.
Yeah, the worst part. See, the pests are in battle, and then people go, "Well, how is it a battle? Because they're making calls, and they're the ones that are doing the assaulting. They're not being assaulted, but they are truly. They have to sit through these awful shows in order to assault it, and that's where we get our most casualties from.
They're like doing the surveillance, you know, those guys who sit in the van just waiting for something incriminating, so, like, ah, fuck.
They got to listen to just babble before something happens.
Yeah.
This is not a lie. I was on my way home from work last night with my girlfriend,
ooh,
and we're in the car, we're listening to a best of.
Yeah.
And she goes, "Hawk, that's E-Rock, right?" Yeah. "And he was also Sex Bagel, right?" Yeah. See, when a joke gets beat to fucking death on your show, you come up with a new show, with a new joke. You keep, you know, the Steve songs have changed 3 times in the past year and a half. They are still playing fucking Would Ye. Do you know how fucking pathetic that is? That show is horrendous. That show fucking sucks. And not only that, I sent you guys some audio yesterday. I think they got it there for you.
Yeah.
Where he's talking yesterday about how FCC has been keeping him down with their finger on the dump button for the past how many years or whatever.
Yeah.
First fucking call from a pest this morning. That motherfucker dumped on the whole fucking call. Whole call. What are you paying for over there? You're still getting 20 minutes of commercials. He's doing live fucking Corona reads or whatever the hell he's doing. Why is anybody even paying for that shit?
It's a revolution. It's a revolution over there. This is the new unbelievable radio that is well worth what people are paying.
In the message boards, some of your message boards, some of the ONA message boards, they smash the shit out of me when you get the fucking when I call into the show. Do you realize that, like, Bob the Juggler called in already today, Mike the Dwarf, Fred the Midget, Frank the fucking Retard, they have the same people on every fucking show, and they're all something the something. I'm going to be Doug the Caller. Is that fucking original enough?
You know what the problem is? We have a lot of listeners. He doesn't. He likes to think he does. He likes to think there's something going on over there. But he's not getting calls from all over the country. He's getting calls from people that subscribe because they were part of the show. They were the hardcore fans. But there's no more calls coming into his show just from regular people around the country because they're not listening to him.
Now, they're not taking our calls because we're not, like, you know...
Oh, yeah, forget about the pest.
...the magician or whatever the hell you
name. Well, you guys just keep the battle going.
But I'll tell you this, we are pounding the phone lines. We've been leaving Tim Sabian some voicemails. We have his office number. We've been getting through to their, we have a couple of their private lines we've been trying to get through also, but they keep telling us that it's busy and they're not taking calls. But amazingly enough, every time I've called, which has probably been about 80 times this morning,
yeah,
the same person I talk to, because I do a different voice and a different name.
Yeah.
I'm the first fucking caller every time from Opie and Anthony.
Well, here's some audio from this morning.
All right, let's listen in.
Let's say hi to Justin. You're on with the great Beetlejuice.
Now, do you take Viagra, Beetle?
Oh, yeah.
All right, thank you. More desperation.
Really?
Huh. That's right.
Isn't that guy late for work?
Yeah. Oh, my God, the desperation over at XM continues
to
grow.
Mm-hmm. How sad.
Yeah.
How sad that guy is.
Yeah. I bleeped that guy off for too much profanity.
Yeah, but sad. It was really sad.
I didn't like the profanity.
See, now he's trying to come up with
yeah,
an excuse.
Cover up why you dumped out of that. Too much profanity. No, you're not willing to confront these people on the air.
Way to do
that's
real radio, Howard.
That's what it is.
Way to do real radio.
Bitching for years. How long did he bitch that dump button had to be used on his show? They're tearing my show apart. The FCC. Bah, bah, bah. I'm being censored. I'm being edited. And he won't confront people. He uses the dreaded dump button. The dump button he bitched about for years and years and years now has his fingerprints all over it because he will not confront our pests. And pests they are, if you didn't hear that. Dugout Doug said 80 calls. Yeah. Only a psychopath pest sits there and calls 80 plus times.
And I don't want
you
these
can't defeat these people.
I don't want
people.
These guys to get down on themselves. You do understand you're getting to him, right?
Oh, definitely.
asshole.
You're not going to get the big phone call on a show, probably, but every time you get through and every time you get you talk to the screener.
Oh, it's killing him.
Because the screener, just like our show, will go and talk to him and say, Howard, it's just out of control. They will not stop.
Remember,
and that drives him nuts.
Remember, he said there are four listeners that they have. That's what Howard said. Our four listeners. Show him what four listeners can do to his fucking phone lines. Go ahead. Show him. There's only four of yous, right? Oh, it should be easy to sort through all the four phone calls there, Howard.
Even if there was, there'd still be 320 calls.
Oh, I know. And you're right, because they're pests, and even four of them could do that. But there's thousands of these people, and they will tie your phone lines up, and you will not put a call through. But like Ope said, don't let that discourage you. You're still winning, because it's tying up his phone, and every time he's got to dump out, it's pissing him off more and more. And he will get off the air today and lose his fucking mind to his staff, to Tim Sabian. Believe me, we've seen this. We know how this works. He will lose his fucking mind. Take pleasure in that.
And eventually he'll just explode on the air, and that'll be the... That'll be the fun.
Oh, the culmination of your fucking hijinks, you pests.
What number are we using today, Doug?
He has other shows. I'm sorry, what was that?
What number are we using today?
For his show?
Yeah.
We'll give him a plug.
What the hell is it? I'm sorry, I got to go back by the computer. I don't have them memorized.
Is it 212-584-5330?
That's one of the office lines.
Oh, that's an office line?
It's like their warm line.
What about 212-584-8880?
That's another one of the warm lines.
Warm lines. Oh, oops.
Yeah, like not really like hotline, but for like, you know, Fred the fucking whack-a-mole guy or whatever the hell, you know. But he has other shows on the channel, and apparently he gets a little upset when we fuck with them. So we'll have to fuck with the show after the show, and then we'll fuck with the show that is after the show about the show. And then I think no matter what they put on the 7 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time time slot, we're just going to slaughter whatever they put in there from now on.
All right, Doug.
We're going to hit whatever that is every night.
All right, have fun with this, Doug.
We're going to have a blast.
All right, give us a report every once in a while, all right?
Okay, and... take care.
All bye, right. Doll.
Bye.
We should all be something to something. I kind of like us all having nicknames. I don't have any.
We'll come up with a nice nickname for you.
How about for everyone, not just me?
We'll start with you.
I don't like that.
Hey, the Truck and Bozo. Where's the Truck and Bozo? Like, what channel? Does anyone know? He does a show on XM for truckers and stuff. He's a cool guy. I've heard his show. It's interesting to listen to, and the truckers really dig the Truck and Bozo. He was talking about us yesterday. Listen to this.
And I hope I can call Opie and Anthony my friends. And because I listen to their show, I know a lot of the guys mention, I find more and more drivers mentioning Opie and Anthony every day. And
so far, so good, right?
Yeah, it's going good, going good.
So far, so good.
I like it.
And I'm just waiting to see. I'm just waiting to see the real battle start, because I don't think it's really started yet between Opie and Anthony and Howard Long. I mean, if I was making $500 million, $100 million a year, I would at least get a haircut. I certainly wouldn't walk around looking like some homeless damn bum who sleeps in a window or sleeps in the door of a store down around Battery Park in New York City. I would get a haircut. Now, that's just simple. I've let my hair grow long a few times, but I've never looked like that. If my father were alive and saw me dressed like that or with my hair like that, he would pull the gun out and shoot me himself.
Oh, thanks for the help, Truck and Bozo.
Wow.
Truck and Bozo.
I like how much he had to explain that, the homeless guy thing. That's right. Like, if I was a farmer riding on a tractor, harvesting corn at 5:30 in the morning, it's just like, evidently you didn't get a laugh on the homeless thing, so you had to fucking explain
it. We love the Truck and Bozo. We just might have to help him out with some material as the Howard thing goes.
I just thought he didn't have to be that harsh.
It was a little harsh.
Was that a run through, or was that actually, did that actually go out on the air?
That went on the air, yes.
Yeah.
He's a fan of the show, and he's helping us out. So, Truck
well,
and Bozo.
In his own way, thank you.
He's on Channel 171 Monday through Friday from 4 to 7 p.m. Eastern Time, all right?
Yes.
God, is that funny. Let's say hi to Tammy in Texas. Tammy, what's up?
I was just going to tell y'all that Howard Stern ripped off that whole, like, virus deal. When he was on Letterman, then he was going to spread, like, the herpes virus and all this bullshit.
He actually stopped himself because he realized he heard that before.
Yikes.
I remember that interview. He was starting down that road and went, and just stopped. So.
Yeah, right. Another thing, I think Howard invented curling, too.
Thank you, Tammy. Bill Burr in studio. He was talking about, the last time we saw you, you were here for Schizo Bill.
Oh,
we haven't talked to you since.
Yeah.
Yeah, I had to go to therapy after that one.
Yeah, Bill actually takes a little guilt home with him.
I'm always with you guys. This is the arc of your fucking with people who are completely defenseless. It starts off a little weird, then it starts getting funny, then it's fucking hilarious, and then it just I don't know what happens.
Goes into sadness.
So when I was standing in that booth and I was looking in here at the back of that guy's head as he was sitting here by himself.
Mm-hmm.
That one point when he just goes, I just want to get out of here.
I just want to get out of here.
Yeah, at that point, I'm just like, all right, somebody.
Let him go.
Throw in the towel already.
We fucked with him for an hour.
You know, Ron and Fez fucked with him.
That bit is being downloaded like crazy off audible.com.
It was fucking hilarious, but still. It was hilarious.
It's always funny until you go back out on the streets of Manhattan.
That's what it is. Then you see kids. You see decent people, and you just, I don't know what happens.
That's what happens. It's the walk from the studio to the parking garage. Now, I take that walk with Bill a lot of times. We leave the show, have a little chat up the sidewalk, and Bill will just talk about how god-awful it was, how he feels so bad about the poor guy that was a schizo, and how we just, you know, I don't know why I jump in while it's happening, and then once the show's over.
I was looking for reassurance. Yeah. I was like, wow, man, that was... That kind of got bad there towards the ending, huh? I just see him. He's got his fucking Vietnam 12-mile stare as he's walking to his SUV.
That's what I do.
You still see those people as human, Bill?
I try to leave it.
Anybody can blow anybody away. He's giving me that speech.
I try to just leave it here in the studio. My walk back to my vehicle is happy, and I'm going home, and that's it. But Bill, in my ear... Just this whole, you know, I felt bad for the guy. I get into my truck and I'm like, what the fuck did we do today? We did this poor guy.
I'm the John Leguizamo character.
Yeah. This poor guy is a schizo and we just hammered him. He just wanted to come in and tell a couple of fucking Billy, get out of my head. Get out of my head. I am not walking with you.
The first 47 minutes, guilt free.
Right.
It was just when he was in here by himself looking like he was 8 years old.
And he was digging for medication.
Oh, yeah. And
he couldn't handle it
anymore.
Talking
in his head. I mean, I would have gone fucking crazy.
Yeah.
I don't know what's going on. It's just like, Jesus.
He was desperate for medication that he accepted water from an imaginary person. It was an imaginary person in his mind, the beekeeper guy. He actually accepted water.
I thought he was going to lose it.
You know, good news, he's going to be part of our St. Paddy's Day broadcast.
Extravaganza.
At the Hard Rock Cafe.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this is the problem I now have. I should have been more like Anthony. I felt so bad, I ended up sending him a couple of CDs. Now he won't stop emailing me.
Now he's your pal.
Yes.
See?
He's
your pal. You gave him some CDs. He's probably thinking that maybe you could help him get into comedy.
Oh, yeah. All of his personalities have been asking questions.
Sure.
Here's what you got to do if he emails you. You email him back, fuck you, bum, send.
How many different personalities from MySpace did he try to have you make friends with? It's the same guy, but it's...
Schizo Bill, Kooky William. Bunch of shitheads.
Let's go to Jim in Pennsylvania.
They all stink.
Jim, go. Come on. You got to jump right in.
What's up, guys?
Hey, man.
I was going to say the funniest part of that entire thing, I thought it was done. He went through the whole Ron and Fez thing, and then Ron comes in his voice. Hey, as always, it's Fez Wiley, and who are you? Dude, I freaking lost it. I had to pull over. It was so funny.
Way to bring it home.
Yeah, that was a good one. Knocked it out of the park.
Let's go to Jen in New Jersey. Jen, what's up?
Hey, I just wanted to let you guys know that I called the numbers that you sent out for Howie,
yeah,
and they're disconnected, both of them.
Hmm.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Way to take it on there, Howie.
Right?
Bring it on.
You said we only had four Army members.
Oh, the Army.
Why would you disconnect phone lines?
Exactly.
Interesting.
We got more audio, by the way. Another pest getting through.
James, you're on the air in Miami. Go ahead, James. Robin just got back from Miami. She said it was fabulous. 80-something degrees.
Beautiful weather.
Hey, Howard. Hey, I just wanted to give you props and, welcome you to satellite radio.
Thank you.
But I wanted to say that Opie and Anthony are better because I listen
to them. You know what? I told Pharrell this about you guys.
Yeah.
He got all freaked out about the ONA Army. And let me tell you something, James. Me, you don't freak out. It is so sad and pathetic to see XM now scrambling for anything they can get. It is so over for them, for XM. It is amazing the fourth quarter hit that these guys took. And James,
mm-hmm.
You know, the Army just is not a really good Army. You know,
oh,
the
my
Army
God.
Bullshit is just so gay.
It's over, Johnny.
What are you, a general or a corporal?
They all do that.
Hung up. Go ahead. Just one.
No, he didn't hang up. You hung up on...
Dude, it's five guys. I've seen them. They've been all out in the streets.
Five guys.
Well, it's five guys, Howard?
I don't know what to do over that,
Howard, don't do this to yourself.
There's millions of people out there who have not...
Shut up, Paul. Shut up, Paul.
Go get them. Make an attractive show.
Oh, no.
It's got to be killing XM. It's just got to be killing them.
No, it's really not.
Look at the momentum. My God.
You look at the momentum around here. They're rebuilding this entire place.
Oh, my God. Look at what's going on with our company.
Yeah, look.
Long pause. You know,
it's just amazing.
You're right, Howard.
It really is.
You're right.
Yeah, that's where the excitement is, actually getting people to do something they hadn't done before.
And not to be a part of this has got to be killing everyone. And getting Oprah isn't going to help. Oprah's not even going to be... you're never going to see Oprah
out
there. It
might have to be Oprah and Anthony first.
Yeah, that
Oprah and Anthony. Oh, she's ready for her own show.
Oprah and Anthony. Now, wait a minute. I kind of like that.
I was going to say, I think that was kind of funny.
The black hole is ready for her own show.
Black hole.
God, Howard. You have all that time to fill. You don't have enough confidence in Robin to give her own show, do you?
Yeah.
Howard. And this is where our excitement comes from. This is very exciting for us to make his life a living hell.
It's a lot of fun. Oh, boy. Is he going to lose his mind? He is going to run to Tim Sabian. Here's what's going to happen after his show today. He's going to run to Tim Sabian over there and start yelling and try some way, shape, or form to have Tim call Opie to stop this. I guarantee you that will happen. He is losing his mind.
Well, we're up for the challenge.
Yep.
So far, Howard is coming out and saying, this is pathetic and all. And they have five listeners or five Army members. I saw the five Army members on the streets. You don't see five people. You see hundreds of people. You don't notice just five people hanging out in a crowd.
No.
You notice hundreds of people that are from the Opie and Anthony show. That's a fact. We've been in the same situations. You don't see five people that are from some cheerleading squad or something.
No.
Yes, but I would.
But if you see a group of people that is enormous, then you take notice.
Yeah. Yeah, five people.
We had
just
a huge presence, and he knows it.
Five people just screwed up your phones.
So we'll take the challenge. So far, he thinks it's pathetic, and he thinks it's we have five Army members.
Yeah.
All right, we're up for the challenge, Howard. Let's see if you're still enjoying it a week in, 2 weeks in,
a month and a weekend. That's right, Jimmy.
Let's say hi to David the trucker. David, what's up?
Yeah, seems that heard little Jimmy Norton last night on the Cool Guy show on the Boneyard.
Oh,
Jimmy,
yeah,
comment.
I didn't. Someone heard you heard me, or someone hurt me?
Yes, I heard you. You were spitting on the Cool Guy.
Oh, is that a promo or something? It was probably a promo I did for the Boneyard Which is a goof, but it was right after we fought with Cool Guy.
You don't tell us when you're going off doing these things?
Oh, I gotta tell you about every offer, I turn them down. No, we had fought with Cool Guy, and in the pro, Charlie Logan had me do promos for Boneyard about Sabbath and all this stuff, a bunch mm-hmm. of them. And he wanted me to shit on Cool Guy, I think, which I really didn't want to because we had kind of had it out. And I was like, yeah, it's done, man. I don't want to be a yeah. dick. That might have been audio actually from this show where I spit. I don't know. Oh. But afterwards, I was like, yeah, why?
All right. Like when Jimmy spits.
Me too, but I didn't want to do it down in D.C. in a promo. It's like, whatever, we're done with that.
Mean-spirited.
Good point, Ant. That's what I'm trying to say.
We got to get back to the Paula Abdul stuff.
Well, that's where we were going.
Well, we could take a break. I don't know where... okay, it's right there. Bill Burns Studio. Bill, what are we promoting today? Oh, you got a gig
yeah,
coming up, right?
Yeah, Bananas. Out in, was it Hasbrook
Heights?
Yeah.
Bananas.
How was Poughkeepsie? I heard you were very funny, which annoyed me.
Oh, it was,
Why does that annoy you?
Because you don't want to hear that your friends are doing really well. You don't like
hearing
that. It
was tremendous, Jim. I was performing in the basement of the Best Western.
Oh, you do the same thing I'm doing, too, yeah.
Your Letterman set was very funny, too.
Oh, thank you very much.
I was listening to that the other day.
Wait, that's got to be weird, by the way. You're on Letterman on Friday on TV, but... In reality, in your real life, at that very moment that you're on Letterman, you're in a basement somewhere doing the same set, right?
Oh, yeah.
That has got to be so weird.
Yeah, just
weird.
A lot more fucks are thrown in there.
Yeah.
Well, you got to
stretch.
No,
it's hilarious. You literally, you do Letterman show. It's like you're whisked to the top of the entertainment. It was Donald Trump last time I was there. I can't remember who the hell it was. But it's some sort of, celebrity making like $20 million a movie. And you're like, wow, I'm right next to
it. I'm here.
And then like the very next day, you're like, keep it going for him, Pete. You stand next to a fake plant and an inflated banana. That was the thing. They had all these bananas. They wait till you go there, dude. It's so... Like, the background is just so wacky, they got all these bananas.
Oh, I've been to Bananas many times. Yeah, it's the worst song in show business history.
What?
Hey, we have no bananas. We have no bananas
that
today.
That gets played?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, did they
that
play that?
Gets
that
played
was, that
there?
Was the theme song for the club.
Well, you know what kills me is they give you a room at the place, and you're on the ground floor, and the comedy room is right below me. So I'm sitting in my room, and I'm listening to the host go, hey, how you fuckers doing? And it's like coming right through the floor. And I'm just thinking, there's no way they rent these rooms out to old people or people with kids. And this dude was clean compared to me. I can't imagine.
Yeah. You up there.
Screaming the fuck
your
word.
Potty mouth.
Yeah, exactly.
I will not stay in that hotel again. Last time I was there, I left.
Really?
Yeah, that hotel stinks. I love the gig,
like
though.
It.
No, I certainly hate it.
Good gig, bad hotel
Great
room,
gig,
huh?
Shit hotel.
But that's got to be weird. You're on Letterman and you're waiting to go downstairs to the basement to do comedy on the same night.
Oh yeah, happens all the time, my friend.
Yeah,
with a lot of
not
girls.
All the time. Every couple of months. Now there's a lot of psychos. I attract psychos. I don't do. I have the exact opposite of like Dane Cook's fans. Like every once in a while I'll get like a Superfinger fan will email me. It's some chick, and when I go to their MySpace page, they'll have like the music, "Send you a bad guy." It's always like some sort of Mandy Moore kind of horseshit going on. I'm like, wow, there's a new demographic. I just do not. I'm jealous. He gets all those fucking 18 to 21 year old Mandy Moore hot chicks, and I get, Schizo Bills and just a bunch of animals.
I would fuck 90% of his fan base.
Oh, yeah.
They're all chicks and they're all hot.
I'd fuck the other 10% just to get to that 90%.
I know, and those are the guys. I'd go through all their assholes just to get to their chicks.
And you could mentally justify knowing what was at the other end of this.
Yeah, what's at the end of it?
Just keep peeking over the line. Like, all right, you're done.
No, his fans are ridiculous.
Yeah. Well, why don't we go to break with Bill Burr on Letterman? We played this once already. Let's play it again for Bill.
Yes.
It was a great set on Letterman. Congratulations, Bill.
Oh, thank you.
And the plug again, where are you going to be?
I'm going to be at Bananas in Hasbrook Heights.
Jersey. Starting Friday?
Starting this Friday and this Saturday.
All right.
And the following week is DC Improv.
Here's our pal on David Letterman, Bill Burr. You're checking out the Opie and Anthony program on this fine Whip 'Em Out Wednesday. It's
Someone's flashing on Pal Talk as we speak here, Anthony. We love the wow. Wow, wow, wow. It's all about wow.
Wow, wow.
That's why I like sitting next to Anthony during these.
Yeah.
That's kind of like you. I just like looking
up. You like looking up. Well, I can't put any
ladies. I like them broads over there with their titties out in the
hoo-ha. Broads. I can't put up any of the cameras today, so I'm not looking at any of the girls.
Well, it is Whip 'em Out Wednesday. Get the wow stickers on your rides, and then you're in the game. There are ladies out there that will flash you if they see the wow. Wow stands for Whip 'em Out Wednesday. The stickers are available through opieandanthony.com. There's an address. You send a self-addressed stamped envelope. We send out the wow stickers. Okay?
Right.
And if you don't want to bother with that crap, make a homemade sign. That works just as well. But this has been working great for many, many years. Bill Burr in studio. We were talking about curling. We were talking about American Idol. I'm trying to see who else is into this curling thing. Bill Burr.
You're really trying.
Another guy.
Aren't you?
But then we were all talking during the break how we want to see like the amateur curlers.
Because this is the best of the best.
They make it look so easy on TV, Olympic curling.
Yeah.
You know, when they're sweeping, they never hit the rock. They never fall down on the rocks.
Dude, that is a great point because this is the best of the best, Olympic curlers. You can't find better curlers than the ones you're watching. So it looks like, oh, that's what you do.
It's Everybody plays touch football. You're not an NFL player.
That's right.
It's just like bowling and all that.
You watch
crap.
Bowling. As a matter of fact, yesterday I'm going through the channels and bowling was on.
Yeah.
So I just stopped for a couple of minutes to check it out. And everyone's bowled. Everyone's, you know, every so often you got nothing to do. You go, let's go bowling. You go bowling. You watch these
You're
guys.
Snowed in.
Yes, snowed in. You go bowling. You watch these guys throw this ball. And it's teetering on the gutter, and then at the last minute, it just curves in right into the pocket, destroys every pin on there, and they consist, boom, boom, one strike after the other, after the other. That's the level of professionalism that we're watching in the curling.
Yeah.
So what is it like now? Because you've been bowling, gutter, two pins, one pin.
Well, because I've been studying this curling thing, and we're taking phone calls. I mean, it's really popular up north, like in Minnesota and all those dumb
Canada.
Places. Canada. You know, and they have leagues and all that.
Dumb
with their winners.
Here's the difference. There's 60 curlers, 40 of them are in the Olympics. There's 20
that
amateurs.
It?
Nobody plays this stupid sport.
I'm telling you, Jimmy, a lot of people are playing this on weekends and stuff.
You
and
know they hit brooms.
I want to see those guys.
No, they're
guys.
Just lonely guys, Dan. Nobody wants to play.
Right.
Does anybody
wants to curl?
Bro, come on.
You know they're getting hammered. You know that they're running down the ice trying to sweep and they're falling down onto the rocks fucking up everything. And then you have to, like, place the rocks back to where you thought they were.
What happens in curling if the broom hits the rock?
We've never seen it happen.
It's got to be a Oh, look at this move.
Bravo.
Well,
that is
I don't know.
No, you wanted to knock
him. You wanted to knock him out.
That was a
nice
bump.
I bet you get, like, a bad broom, kind of like you get a bad pool cue.
Bad pool cue. It's a little warped.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not enough
that
bristles.
Could happen. In the amateurs.
You know the guys don't have any form. They're just throwing it with two hands sideways and hoping for the best. You run down maybe halfway, sweep a little.
Oh, that's what it becomes by the end of it. You're just waiting for your buddy to run down so you can catch him in his Achilles. Slide it right into him.
What trumps curling? Like, if you want to go curling, nah, I got to shift through my shit. I swallowed a tooth. What do you say?
Oh. But it would be a lot different, you got to think.
Wow, that's a good move. Look at this.
No, that was a horrible hit.
No, but he's going to
Hey, you're allowed
sweep
to
it out,
do
sweep
that?
It out.
Yeah. Wait. See, you're allowed to sweep in front of the other team's rock if you knock it and it's going out of the ring.
Yes.
To speed it up.
After it hits, then the other team that's kind of on defense can start sweeping away.
Come on, that's page one.
Yeah. I didn't know that.
That's what I'm telling you.
I just learned something new about curling.
There's incredible strategy. You hit the rock. Right now, the rock that was hit, that guy was just waiting around. He could start sweeping, maybe sweep some of the pebbles in
that's
front to
slow
it down.
That's what they just did. They sped it up to knock it out of the ring.
Yes, that's what's so cool about this sport.
Well,
there's a lot of strategy.
It's a fabulous game then that I'll watch 24 hours a day.
Professor, what does the sweeping do? Is it the friction?
I asked that same question the other day. I am not even sure.
They spray pebbles, like little pebbles, onto the ice surface with this special hose.
And the sweeping gets it away and makes less friction.
Yeah, I guess you're smoothing down the pebbles a little bit.
If you don't sweep as much, you can adjust the speed and sometimes the direction. Look at this move. Look at this. Knocks him out.
That was an easy shot, though.
So wait a minute.
That was there was nothing.
Wasn't
to
an
that.
Easy shot.
That's that thing is moving because of these pebbles. They're not on ice.
It's ice.
It's ice. But
it
then
is ice.
Then there's pebbles that are on top of the ice.
A little bit, but there's little so ice, little,
tiny,
ice,
tiny little ice
minuscule.
Pebbles.
Ice pebbles.
It wasn't slippery enough.
Yeah.
No. Just, yeah.
But that way, that's how you can vary the speed and direction of the rock.
I'm obsessed with this curling. I'm sorry, but I am. I'm sorry.
Oh, this is the contract of wifely expectations.
Curling huge
it's
in
like
Canada.
A contract where know it that. Leads to initial. What a prick.
Hold on 1 second. Effing Eddie from Kentucky. Go ahead, Eddie.
Hey, Dig, man. I coached ice hockey at Nashville right, a couple of years ago, probably right after that first Olympics or last Olympics. And I've got my little kids I'm coaching, and I'm a transplant from up north. And we go out there, and there's these circles painted in the ice, and there's all these fucking stones with handles on them. So the little guys start playing with them before we start practice, and I'm like, it's fucking curling in Nashville, Tennessee, and these guys are real serious about it.
It's taking over, I'm telling you.
Redneck's curling. I'm going to find out when these days.
Redneck's curling.
I'm going to find out when they do it and take pictures. It's got to be a blast. We're always finding bottles, beer bottles and stuff on the side, so I'm thinking it's like bowling.
It's got to be a great drinking sport.
Well, it's Nashville, Tennessee.
It's got to be.
There's beer cans littered around everything.
Eric, yeah, outside the library.
Yeah.
Eric, what's up?
I was so searching for the reference.
What's up?
Morning, boys.
This is the last curling call for a while, by the way.
Please.
Hey, Opie, if you want to try it, we have a private curling club right here in Jersey.
A private we're restricted.
Well, no, it's privately owned. We own the
private
the building in the
private.
Ice.
No Jews or African Americans.
Yeah.
I can give you my phone number off air if you want to try. Come out and take a look.
It's called Bushwood.
Where?
It's in South Plainfield. It's right off of 287. It's maybe a half an hour away from the city.
Why do you have it as a private club? Do you think that droves are going to come in, or I don't understand why it's private.
No, it's privately owned, like an elf, so that we can have a bar and everything.
Do you
like
really
that.
Think you have to worry about the schwoogies running down the ice with a broom?
You tell Russ Howard I'm gunning for him. He's half as good as he says he is. He's going to have to play me to prove it.
That's funny.
You trumped me, too. I had a good thing going, and you just made everyone forget about that. You knocked my joke rock right out of the circle.
Oh, I was curling. That's We're right. joke curling. Trying to knock someone else's joke.
I had a good joke. It was heading toward the bullseye, and you just, wham, slammed it right out of the circle.
Sweeping with my Caddyshack reference.
Actually, mine was more of a guard. It was an all right joke.
Yeah, so Opie, if you want to try it, I'll teach you how.
No, dude, I was just...
Are you going to get behind him like the way a guy teaches a hot chick a tennis swing?
We'll move up the end of the broom for him.
Right. He's going to be sliding with him.
Yeah.
I think this place is restricted, Wang, so don't tell me you're Jewish.
Yeah. Yeah, I would not want to play the game. I don't like cold games.
Yeah,
like
but when you're on
ice. Dude, all you need, I don't want to play on the ice. Like, 7 or 8 douchebags out there, you're all going to start talking shit, and any game's going to be fun.
Any game is fun?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You think if your buddies are out there, you'd actually enjoy the curling?
You would be talking. You talk shit the whole game. How the person slides, his
you
fat
suck.
Ass.
You suck.
Look at him trying to sweep.
What kind of insults do they hurl? You curl like a Hawaiian. Some other warm climate area. You curl like a Brazilian. Oh, those are fighting words. Douchebags.
When does boredom set in, though, and you just start throwing the rocks at your friends and stuff?
After the first push.
Oh, that's what happens.
You know, you take it seriously for the first end. It's a 10-end game, and you're like, you know what?
You whale another rock into the one they're sweeping.
That's hilarious. You know what? That's the BB gun factor. Like, remember when you're a kid and you buy a BB gun, it's like the first thing you do, a little target practice, and then 3 minutes later, you're like trying to blow your friend's brains out.
It does escalate fast.
That's true. All right, it's a little nice about setting up
cans. You get
cans.
Firecrackers. Ooh, let's try to blow up a tin can. 5 seconds later, you stick it in somebody's pocket.
Yeah, starts out with putting a little Dixie cup over it.
Yeah.
And it ends, throwing them at each other.
There's a frog hopping around. What is this in my asshole? What's that crackling noise?
All right. Hey, we went off on an hour and a half tangent.
Oops.
We're coming back on the highway here. So we were talking about Paul Abdul.
We've curled our bits, Opie.
Yeah, we're curling back to the
curling
American
back.
Idol bit. Are you watching American Idol, Bill Burr?
No.
I know. So.
You got to watch it just to hear what Simon says. Guy's unpredictable.
No, you know what? I actually watch it the first few weeks and everybody really sucks.
Yeah, that's
when I usually bail, Bill.
Yeah.
But this ass got me hooked on it.
Now, you
got to
watch
it. I'm into the end now on this one.
Now they gussy them up. They dress them all up. At first, they don't care what they come in looking like. But then they do hair, makeup, clothes, teach them how to present themselves, how to address the camera.
Then they end up like singing like Barry Manilow songs.
It's awful.
And then they critique it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's awful.
It's like Barry Manilow sucked when he sung that song.
And all the other shows, it's all about Simon and what he has to say. On this show, it's all about Paula and what she has to say.
Yeah. Because she is, as far as I can tell, I don't know. Yeah. What am I, a doctor? Of course not. So I don't know. But looking at her and having looked at people that have been under the influence of some type of narcotic, she does have a similar look and sound and delivery to those people that I have seen that are on narcotics.
Oh.
Which would lead me to believe, in my personal opinion, which isn't worth a shit, that perhaps there's something going on there.
You don't think it's just guilt? Or the fact that she knows if she actually auditioned for the show back in the day, she would have got booed off?
Oh, yeah. Oh, if she actually would have. Well, not if our judge was E-Rock.
Yes, sir.
Who is a huge Paula Abdul fan.
Oh, do you like Paula Abdul?
Huge.
No.
Oh, now you're going to say no?
This is his old theme music we used to play years and years ago.
So what?
He likes this. Look, he's dancing.
Yeah. You right now want to jump up and yell the two steps forward, two steps back. How the fuck that went?
Do
you like her edgier stuff, like cold-hearted
back?
Yes.
Cold-hearted
and you starve to death because you're right there.
I'm with you, Bill. The edgier stuff. All right, so we got some clips of Paula Abdul just slurring and just saying dumb stuff.
Yeah.
From last night's American
Allegedly. Would it bother you if I kept throwing the word allegedly, but in the wrong places where you didn't need it?
Yeah, she allegedly said. No, she did.
It's on Wednesdays. Allegedly.
She was good. A little sharp moments, but it was good.
Mandisa, you were phenomenal.
Thank you.
And I got to tell you something. To take on Hart is pretty challenging. And, you know, Carrie Underwood took on Hart and sang Alone. I think you broke the record for just magnificent. You were fantastic. What a way to start the show.
You broke the record for magnificent. It's just she and her eyes are at half mast. She's just looking around. She's confused, trying to find the next word.
She's teetering fantastic. Into Tara Reid territory.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We noticed also that the girls that are in this competition, because they were all the girls last night and the guys are tonight and then they vote tomorrow. Fox is trying to figure out some way to have this show on 7 days a week. All the girls, when they sing, they have their singing voice. But when they talk, I guess they're singing so much that their voice is Tara reading out on them. They all are like doing their interviews with Ryan Seacrest, and they're, it's been a wonderful time here. We all get along so well. Like their vocal cords are so shot that sometimes they just shut off like Tara Reid's did. She's got the raspy voice. It's been wonderful. We're like one big Emily Stitting hotel, and I rehearsed this song so much. It means so much to me and my family. When I was growing up, this CD was all the time, and I from it used to sing it all the time in the car when we were on grandmother's house.
Kelly, here are the great things about you. You're unpretentious. You don't have the diva attitude. You have the likability factor up the scale to the highest level, and that's going to carry you in your reel, and that is wonderful quality to keep with you.
Up the scale to the highest level. She's a babbling idiot.
Well, allegedly.
Allegedly, no, that's for sure. Oh.
My hat goes off to you. You're my idol. You're my idol. You're like a little firecracker. You're the Energizer Bunny, and you avoided a wardrobe malfunction all at the same time. And you got everybody up dancing and smiling. And you know what? You are a showman, showwoman, I think.
Thank you.
Good for you.
Showman, showwoman, I think.
Thank you.
Thank you. Would you? Thank you.
Is she really that bad, though, you think, in these clips?
Nah, the clips aren't really giving it the justice that it deserves. She to see her at the same time, her mannerisms really help out.
Supposedly she's stuttering in this one.
I want somebody just once on American Idol to sing, I'm crying over you, crying, crying. That was the song he sang when he was dancing backwards.
Would you?
Sorry, I disagree. I felt that it was very brave of you to take on that and be very ethereal with it, with the falsetto and be very intimate, because we've heard you go in and out. You're very trained. You took that song and you did exactly the right thing with that song. So I feel it may not have been the most popular choice, but you still did the right thing with that song. So you made me listen.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, she's not that bad in these clips.
Really
she
not bad.
She sounds more like maybe like a family pet died that day.
Yeah.
Turtle got crushed in the driveway.
Well, this one was great because she had nothing good to say to this one lady.
Yeah, and she's like the nice
so she
judge,
has to come up with something every time? Listen to what she has to say.
She has two turtles, by the way, Cuff and Link.
I'm disagreeing with you a lot tonight, really. First of all, I think you look stunning. I think you look stunning.
Stunning.
Sharp notes, a few. So what?
Okay, fine.
Your performance was powerful. Your showmanship was on point. I thought you did a lovely job.
No, that's not the one.
All right, she's going to love this job.
Screw it. That was supposed to be the one where she just says, well, you're beautiful.
Yeah, she goes, well, you're beautiful.
That's all she could say.
Hey, thank you, Paula.
Say about that.
It's a singing competition, you idiot.
I like when Randy gets straight and says dog.
Oh, and he's got the dog pound.
What?
Yeah, all the guys that were sitting waiting for tomorrow's competition, which is tonight, he would go, what do you think, dog pound? And they'd all wave their fist in the air and go, ooh, 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 you know.
That's
I've seen that
Hall.
Somewhere. Yeah, he completely bit Arsenio's bit from 20 years ago.
Is he really trying to get back in touch with his roots and apologize to black people for being in Journey?
Yes, he was the bass player in Journey for a while.
When the fuck was that?
After the original bass player left.
After all the hits, let's just put it
that way. After all the hits.
Oh.
Loving, touching, squeezing, you won't be here. No. Wheel in the Sky, no Randy Jackson.
When the lights,
when the lights go
when
down.
They, when they were opening for Great White.
Yeah, then you'll see Randy Jackson.
Open Arms.
Open Arms, sorry. Ross Valerie was the bass player for Journey back then.
Yeah.
If anybody want a little trivia. Want to know who Randy Jackson
is. Actually, I didn't know that one. Very good, Anthony.
Yes.
Hey, what's up with this contract, Bill Burr? You emailed this to everyone last night.
Oh, this is just a cute little contract that this guy who's up on, allegedly. Is,
attaboy, Bill.
Is up on some sort of child abuse, sexual assault
all right, who is
charges.
Let me just preface that.
Yeah, a little
tattletale. At least on this show, right?
Rat.
And,
the, full of rats, even on the kids.
On the smoking gun, they had his contract that I guess he had his wife sign, if she was actually going to be his wife. It's called the Contract of Wifely Expectations.
All right. Now, what is the problem with this?
I failed to see the problem. I just want to, you know, give this guy, you know, to have the balls to actually write this up. I don't know what the fuck he said to his wife to get her to sign this shit.
Did she sign it?
I have no idea. I mean, the guy was married, I
think.
There's
spaces where she has to initial after every paragraph, every point.
You know what? I have
made.
To be honest here. My girl fucking sent me this shit. I read the first paragraph and a half, and I'm like, this is a fucking home run. I didn't read the rest of it.
Because I'm thinking the other way. I'm thinking this could be one of those joke emails that you just send to your buddies at the office.
No, this it's, was on, the smoking
yeah, it's
gun.
On the smoking
gun. They're pretty good.
So there's some credibility behind this.
Yeah,
huh?
They don't.
Jim, they're pretty good over there, right?
So, yeah, they have a pretty good track record.
Because this almost looks like the same shit as, like, why chocolate is better than men.
No, this guy looks like a guy that was having some issues with a wife and figures to let me lay down the law in a contract form.
Incidentally, this is true. I've read a contract like this that was signed by Carla Homolka. Paul Bernardo had her sign a contract like this. It was in a book. It was very similar in nature. Yeah, like, when you bring me a drink, you will bring it quickly and happily. It was like that exact type of contract, and it was
so these are just
it.
Common sense things that they decided to write down.
Well, a lot of times what will happen is, and I hope I don't come off as being sexist, but you know, the hole that you've dragged in to ruin your life won't exactly get it, so you have to jot down a few things to keep her on the straight and narrow.
Hey, we got to back up 1 second here. Brian in West Virginia.
Hey, why is Jimmy getting away with that two turtle joke?
It was, well, it wasn't a great joke, but it was a reference from something, sir.
Sir, if I thought he actually uttered that out as a true joke, I would have laid into
that.
Him. I understand he was making a Rocky joke. And
yeah, it's a reference to Rocky.
It's very funny.
Thank you. It wasn't like a real punchline, sir. I wasn't like I thought of like two words that go together, shirt and collar, no, cuff and
cuff and link. Yeah. And Jimmy has come up with some very funny Rocky jokes about the miscarriage in the pet store. So he gets a gimme on the cuff and link.
But it wasn't the miscarriage. Fucking kid came out with a 30-year-old man's head of hair. He had Eric Logan hair when he was
That's
born.
That's right. It wasn't a miscarriage.
Baby.
It was almost.
It should have been.
Paulie almost gave her that miscarriage.
Yeah.
Coming
and yelling
at her.
She falls on bird feed. Fucking.
First she's lugging around a big thing of dog food, ready to drop a kid.
Yeah, he's bouncing a rubber ball. Stupid dago.
Comes in yelling. Some wop.
All right, so back to this contract.
What about me? Shut up.
Yeah. You're wrong. Friends don't know. That was in 3 when he got stylish.
Yeah.
He's good.
All right, contract of wifely expectations. It says, for purpose of clarification, you and any form of it will refer to...
Whatever her
That's
name
her
is.
Name.
Oh, her name.
Blank Fry.
I and any form of it will refer to Travis Frey.
Fry.
Yeah. Frey.
Frey, Fry.
Whatever the guy's name is.
So it starts off with the hygiene.
Hygiene and self-care.
This is what he expects.
And she had to initial this. You will shave every third day, which includes underarms, chest...
Chest. She probably had nipple hair and he hated it.
Oh. What is that third word there?
Legs.
Oh, legs. You know, what every girl shaves. Legs and pubic area, navel to anus, in parentheses. All areas are to be completely clean shaven. Above your vaginal slit, you may have a patch of pubic hair in any shape that must be centered above your vaginal slit. It must measure no greater than 2 inches by 1 inch and will maintain a hair length of less than 1/3 of an inch.
How do you not love this?
Please initial here.
There's not a guy in the country that wouldn't have loved to have the courage to give this to his awful wife.
Yeah, if you're lucky, maybe a Valentine's Day, your birthday's coming up, maybe once every couple of years, you did something right. And she'll do this. This guy is expecting this every third day.
Isn't this the old head of the household bit from the Honeymooners? Didn't Ralph try to give Alice this contract? Alice, shave that box. Clothes and other apparel.
All right.
You will wear only thigh-high...
Thigh-highs.
Oh, thigh-highs, garters, and only thong panties. The only exception will be during your menstrual cycle, at which time you could wear either or both. Oh, either or both.
Mm-hmm.
Of your half of your shoe purchases will be high heels, 2 inches or more. You will then wear high heels more often. You will give me all non-thong panties and all pantyhose, all tights, all knee-high and or ankle-high nylons. You will be able to keep 5 pair of non-thong panties of your choice for use during your menstrual cycle. Initial here.
What is fucking wrong with this?
I gotta call Bravo Sierra. Come on. Is this real?
This guy wrote this contract for his wife.
I'm telling you, they must have had, I'm gonna go out on a limb, kind of like Paul and Carla had, some weird dom sub like thing where she might have even been turned on by this complete...
Really?
Yes.
Well, this guy is on the smoking gun because of some kind of charges.
I don't know, actually.
It's allegedly, isn't it?
It's here's
the story right here.
All right, hope he's got the story. Thank you, Travis, for flailing wildly, and it's completely distracting me and giving me zero information. Thank you for that.
A Council Bluffs man is accused of kidnapping his own wife, and prosecutors allege he devised a marriage contract to establish what his wife was to do and when she was to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Travis Frey, or Frey, 33, is accused, among other things, of giving his wife chances to win Good Behavior Days.
That's fantastic.
We have to read every word
of
this contract now.
This is just, they started off doing a little role-playing.
Yeah.
They didn't have a safety word.
Yeah, and this is where it went.
When she was saying, get me out of the trunk, it was just making his dick stiffer. And she didn't realize that he was serious.
You know what's hotter than having one of those scenarios with a safety word is keeping it going even while she screams the safety word. Yeah. Hotter for the guy.
Green apples! Green apples!
Yeah.
Putting your
take it, bitch.
Yeah. That's our safety word. Fuck you. There is no safety word.
You're choking her, fucking her ass. She's trying to yell green apples. She starts yelling Macintosh, red delicious.
Green apple! Green apple!
Choke on it. Well, I said this guy was up on child molestation charges. That was my fault.
Well, here's the rest of the story. Well, according to court records, Fry's wife told police her husband tied her to their bed with a rope and sexually assaulted her at least three times. Mm-hmm. Fry's wife also provided police with an alleged marriage contract, which was entitled Contract of Wifely Expectations, which we have in front of us here. In it, Fry allegedly gave his wife chances to earn good behavior days, or GBDs, mm-hmm. by complying with certain demands such as hygiene and self-care. You will shave every third day. The contract states you will be naked within 20 minutes of the kids being in bed. We haven't gotten to that
part yet. That's in sleepwear and sleeping. Don't ruin it.
All right. The document spells out how many points can be earned by performing certain sex acts.
Uh-huh.
Wow. Sit down and get comfortable, kids. We got to read every word of this contract.
Yeah. You know what's funny is beer commercials have this exact same theme, like, you know, the guy fantasy.
Right.
There's always like some your chick's always dressed like a fucking cheerleader.
She's dressed like a cheerleader or the little French maid, and she's signing this with a smile on her face.
Yeah, this guy's just trying to make it happen. He had a dream. And it's not contract of wifely demands. It's expectations.
Absolutely.
This is to be expected of her.
All right, let's get to sleepwear and sleeping.
Sleepwear and sleeping.
Yeah.
And if I stammer through a little of this, it's because
it's
the
really
copy
hard to
we
read.
Have is a little, the font is small and
I thought you were still
smeared.
Doing your Paula Abdul impression.
Yeah, yeah. When we are at home and alone as a family, you will be naked within 20 minutes of the kids being in bed and then sleep naked unless otherwise instructed. If I am not home when the kids go to bed, you are still to be naked before I return home. The only exception will be during, of course,
your menstrual cycle.
When we are not at home and not alone as a family, you will try to ensure that we sleep together. If we do sleep together, you will sleep naked. I will make exceptions for sleepwear, but only if you do not ask for them. It's under his own discretion.
Absolutely.
Exception will be given based on how well you follow this contract in its entirety. If we do not sleep together, your sleepwear must conform to the standards for expectations.
Exceptions. This
I'm
is a
sorry.
Contract. Don't make it up.
You know something? It's very hard. It's very smeared.
This is so legally
point
binding.
It out. When exceptions are given, the following is acceptable and is your choice. T-shirts, pajama tops, or gowns, as long as the overall length is not past your knees. Panties, any type, can be worn also. Absolutely no bottoms. Shorts, pajama pants, or full gowns can be worn. When we are in bed together, I can cuddle, spoon, hold, or touch you in any way, as long as it does not excessively disruptive is not excessively disruptive to your sleep.
Do you know how hard his cock was writing this?
Yeah.
Do you understand the fucking masturbatory fantasies that were being fueled by writing this?
So this guy's saying he can cuddle and touch her as long as it does not excessively disrupt your sleep? Is he throwing her a bone there?
I guess.
Yeah, he's actually showing that he's, you know,
like, hey, I can touch you and stuff, but if it disturbs your sleep, I'll back off.
Right. Let's go to Spike in Chicago. Spike.
Hey guys.
Hey.
Jimmy's right. This is a in some circles, you know, like dom sub circles, this is a slave contract.
Oh yeah.
But they're a married couple.
Yeah, they're married.
Even sure, married couples, non-married couples, they'll write up contracts stipulating everything from. What they have to do in bed to what they have to wear and how they give oral sex, all that kind of stuff.
There's so much I just don't know about out there. Believe me, I'm rifling through thoughts to put down for a contract of my own. I love this idea. All right, Spike, thank you. Let's go to Charles in Delaware. Charles?
Hey, question. Hey, good morning.
Hi, Charles.
Hey, man, can you speculate? What do you think would be a max hardcore marriage contract, Jimmy?
Jesus, I don't know. You will wear a septic tank on your head. You will not cry when I bring back memories from when you were four. Yeah, awful stuff.
I'm digging my time.
All right, let's get back to the contract of wifely expectations. My time.
When we are at home and alone as a family, from when you are to be naked until 12... Do you know if that's PM or AM? Until 12 a.m.
They go to bed early, it looks like, because they got the kids and stuff.
Yeah. Or for 3 hours, whichever is later, will be my time.
Oh, no.
This time will be time you will devote solely to me, whereas you will be in my service to do, and underlined, anything and everything I want, which may or may not be sexual in manner. When we are not home, or not alone as a family, my time will be modified as follows. You will have your clothes, you will be able to speak openly, and you won't have to perform anything sexual before we are in bed. However, all other rules still apply.
Of course they do.
But if this is your time, isn't it really our time?
Dude, this guy is setting himself up for the greatest fucking marriage ever.
Oh, he's trying.
Absolutely.
I'm really trying to find something in here that I disagree with.
Now there's like a sub little thing he spells out. During my time, you will and will not. There's wills and will nots.
Let's hear the will nots first.
The will nots. During my time, you will not argue about anything with me or to me. That
should be in every contract.
This guy's a pimp.
He really is.
You will not complain about anything to me or about me. You will not cry, sob, whine, or pout.
Oh.
You will not sigh, moan,
bulk,
or otherwise show displeasure or unhappiness.
He's saying don't be cunty.
Right.
During my time.
He's basically saying be a guy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You will not raise your voice at or to me. You will not be condescending to or about me. You will not ask for anything from me or of me or for me.
Right.
You will not be distracted from me by other things.
Okay.
That is like the top 10 things or 8 things that you complain of. Every guy complains about their
that
girl.
That is amazing. This is actually in the same contract that the interns have to sign with Opie.
U.S.
During my time, now the wills come up.
Okay.
You will be subservient, submissive, and totally obedient. You will do what you are asked, when you are asked, exactly how you are asked. You will be cheerful and adoring towards me. You will be close at all times unless otherwise told to. You will perform any and all sexual acts, including anal penetration and or ingestion of cum when told
to.
He should have put in parentheses and not necessarily in that order.
Let me see.
No?
Perform sexual. Oh, acts excluding?
Yeah.
Wait a minute. You will perform any and all sexual acts, excluding anal penetration and or ingestion of cum when told to. Oh, I guess she doesn't like being fucked in the ass. Or
is that a
so
typo?
So he kind of threw her a bone. Maybe.
Maybe he just doesn't know the difference between exclude and include.
No. Here's what it is. Here's the sentence. You will perform any and all sexual acts when told to. In between the commas is excluding anal penetration and or ingestion of cum. So he's saying this. Look, with those exceptions, you're going to do anything you're told when told to. That makes perfect sense.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
right. Very good.
So he's saying he's not saying that he's not going to do that shit.
No, he won't fuck her in the ass and she doesn't have to drink cum.
Doesn't have to. If she wants to, that's fine.
Right, but that nullifies the whole contract.
He
what's the use of having one?
He can't force her into that. She must have really put up, if she agreed to the rest of it, but put up a fight to the ass and the cum drink, wow, she must have really put up some battle.
This is like a Bob Eatman negotiation going on. All right, look.
That's all she gets is that she's not going to get fucked up the ass or have to drink cum.
Whenever you negotiate a contract, there's always things you're willing to give up to get other things.
I think she got my divorce lawyer.
Right. So she's like, look, you know, give me the anal and the swallowing. I don't want to do
right.
that. If you give me that, then I don't have to do that. I'll give you this.
I'll give you the nude when the kids go to bed.
But he also says she's not allowed to mention his name on her show.
Oh, yes.
Can you imagine if your daughter signed, you'd just be like, you signed this shit?
You signed this?
Yeah, let's go to Tony in Wisconsin.
I think you disown her long before this contract comes across you.
Hey, Tony.
Yeah, I would just like to put in my nomination, Man of the Year.
Man of the Year?
Yep.
Without
a doubt, this
right.
guy is...
We got two more pages to go here.
All right, good behavior. Good behavior. Since there will be no trading, negotiations, or conciliations of any kind... You are given chances to earn good behavior days, GBDs. To receive GBDs, you are to be totally compliant with everything requested or expected of you and perform everything with complete and total enthusiasm. In addition, GBDs will be given when you do things from the descriptions below when not expected. If you try to perform something not expected and I tell you no, you will receive half GBDs. Specific GBD info is listed at the bottom right of each description. Each GBD can be used to get out of doing the thing requested or expected of you for an entire day. Wow, that's a pretty good deal. With the following exceptions: birthdays, anniversaries, shaving, and sleepwear. Isn't that pretty much everything? Unless someone is staying with us or we are staying with someone, then it can be used for sleepwear also. GBDs can be redeemed any time after you receive them to the end of the next quarter. You must notify me by 12 p.m. of the day you are using a GBD or it cannot be used.
You know,
this guy's got rules like a bank and
I
shit.
I love him.
You know what I was just picturing? Is this guy at work and every guy standing around the water cooler bitching about their wives?
Yeah.
And then he just pulls out this contract.
Hey, guys, let me...
This is how you do it.
Let me show you how it's done, gentlemen.
Or he starts bragging. I make my wife do this, and this. Bullshit.
Bullshit. Oh,
shit.
Bullshit?
You know, yeah.
Let me show you a signed copy of this, my friend.
Yeah, subset A, paragraph 6 clearly states that there will be a shaved anus in my face at 8:19 every night, unless it's Monday Night Football.
All right, now it's the misbehavior and non-compliant
part of the contract.
Yeah. Misbehavior is when you complain about what is requested or expected of you, or when you try to negotiate something else instead of what was requested or expected of you. If this happens, you will lose 5 GBDs per incident.
Wow.
Wow, so you earn 1 GBD at a time, but you can lose 5. It is also misbehavior when you perform half-assed. If this happens...
If you're just calling it in.
You will lose the GBDs.
If you're just calling in your anal performance, you're going to be docked.
So if you...
She's not rubbing his balls during the blowjob.
Get
you're calling it in.
That was really a subpar blowjob.
Yeah. It is also misbehavior when you perform half-assed. If this happens, you will lose the GBDs that would have been given to you. So if you try a little extra credit to earn a GBD and you fuck it up, you don't only not get the GBDs that you would have, you lose GBDs.
And you know what's hilarious is after, like, the sexual act, she's like the figure skater sitting there waiting to get her scores.
All out of breath and sweating, talking to her coach.
Somebody holding her hand.
How is someone gives her flowers?
Yeah.
I think we should just...
Hey, you didn't rub the taint. It was a little half-assed. People throwing roses at her.
She's going to be disappointed with this GBD score.
I think we should start a GBD program with the guys around here.
With the workers and interns and... Oh, how many GBDs would E-Rock lose? Oh, every time something fucks up on the computer.
Oh.
It will be a bacon, egg, and cheese sandwich.
Yes.
Here we go. Where are we?
If it continues after the GBD are lost, then you are considered non-compliant. However, it is not misbehavior to state that there are specific situations requested or expected of you that can hurt or cause pain. Okay, so if she's going to be in pain, she can make a request that not continue, and that won't be considered misbehavior.
I think he's showing his sensitive side.
This guy is a little too sensitive.
This guy's mushy as far as I'm concerned.
It is also not misbehavior to suggest ways to avoid those specific situations other than to propose not to do them.
Why don't you just sign over the farm, pal?
Jesus Christ. Dude started off all strong, and now in misbehavior and noncompliance, he's fucking it all. He's giving it away.
Pussy whipped.
I know what this guy's
all
doing.
Right, Bill?
If he slapped this fucking thing down, like 100% of everything that he wanted, that you're going to shut the fuck up and do everything I want, she's not going to sign it. So what he's got to do is just give her some gray area that maybe, hey, this guy's got a good heart if I don't want to do it.
But later
You think during the middle of the act when this psycho's dick is standing up, he hears anything but yes?
It's going to hurt me. I suggest we do it another way. Yeah, he's going to go, oh, okay. That was paragraph what?
Yeah,
no, he's going to ram it home and say, shut up. Read paragraph one where it says no complaining.
Yeah.
During my time.
What you will not do.
Right. You are to do everything that is requested or expected of you. If you do not, you are considered noncompliant. You are also noncompliant if you start something and cannot or will not finish, even if you state that you are in pain or something hurts. All right, so once you start it,
yep.
It's over, Johnny. You got to finish.
Once you let me poke the head in,
right.
It's all going
okay,
in.
Now it makes sense.
It's like a cell phone contract. Between the hours of 8 and 12.
This guy's a genius.
Free nights and weekends.
How many minutes do I get?
He fucks her in the ass. It's considered roaming.
He gives her something in the one paragraph, but the very next paragraph, he figures out a way to take it back.
So he's a genius.
No, he doesn't. He figures out a way to stop this lying whore from making excuses. Ow, that hurts. Once she starts something,
right.
Doesn't like it.
Once you start it, you have to finish.
I think Jim's onto something, because I think the will not list of shit just kind of it just cuts out all her bitching.
If you are non-compliant, then you lose 3 times the amount of GBDs you would have been given. If you don't have enough GBDs to cover the loss, then you will be tied to the bed, and I will do whatever I wish to you. This will continue every night until you are ready to be compliant, at which time you will need to apologize and explain how you are ready to be my sex slave again.
See, that's his out right there.
Yep.
All he's got to do, if she keeps bitching that she doesn't want to do something, he totally decides when she loses the GBDs. So all he's got to do is just get her balance down to zero, and he ties her to the bed.
Now he ties her to the bed, does whatever, it doesn't matter, negates everything he's given her.
But he does give her a chance to explain how she's ready to be the sex slave again, which I like because there's always room for a compromise. It's important.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sleep time and on demand. Sleep time is from an hour after we are in bed until an hour before the alarm is set for. You are to set the alarm according and tell me what for time it's set for, you dolt. That's what it says.
Yeah.
If it happens that we are traveling or we are at an event and we are not able to be home or in bed, then sleep time will be considered 11 p.m. to 7 a.m. During this time, you are not expected to perform anything. However, at any time, I can cuddle, spoon, hold, or touch you. There are certain circumstances when you are to perform any and all requests immediately. This will, on demand, mean what I say, when I say, where I say, how I say. The circumstances are any time from 20 minutes after the kids are in bed up to an hour after we are in bed. Any time from an hour before the alarm is set to when the alarm goes off. Anytime we are alone and without the kids, 8 to 11 p.m. and 6 to 7 a.m. when traveling. So he's leaving himself every opportunity.
But you know what, dude? Like, it's funny, but I'm like reading over this with you, and yeah. There's definitely flaws in here that are probably not going to hold up legally.
Could be a couple of flaws.
Yes.
Yeah, but if you initial it, I mean, this is like a rental car contract.
You're pretty much...
Yeah.
Yeah, you have a contract when you rent a car, right? You got to
initial this. They make sure you initial
the insurance.
So there's no
Is she taking the extra insurance or not?
Yeah.
On this,
yeah.
You have to bring your asshole back full of load the same way it left, or else
they charge you extra per mile.
Dressing
up for special events that we are to dress up for. When we are going to someone else's house, or just the two of us are going out, your clothes must meet my approval. General rules are. Panties are always optional and need not be worn. Only thigh high and garter, no pantyhose. If you are not wearing high thigh highs and garter, then no panties. All skirts no lower than 2 inches below the knee, unless it's for church.
Oh, great. He's religious.
GBD, one for each time that was not expected, one per week, only if you had to.
That makes no sense. Yeah, at this point, like Jim was saying, his dick is so fucking hard.
Engorged. It's not,
like, there's more typos.
He's seeing spots in front
of his
eyes.
Lefty. his cock is hitting the bottom of the computer desk.
He started off. The end of last page, he had a typo. Now sentences aren't starting to make sense. It's like when you read, like a veteran's, like, battle journal.
Right, yeah.
He starts
they
off,
start
wow, it's pretty
it.
Sunny over here in
Been
Nuremberg.
Been quiet lately, missing you. And then the end is just this scroll of, my God, the death, the destruction, the bodies. Guy's got clear stuff just caked on the mouse.
He's gluing, his cock is gluing itself to the bottom of the desk just from being pounded and held and fist wrapped around it.
Because at this point, he can't believe he's going to get away with this.
No, he's looking at the wedding photos.
At this point,
photos.
He's thinking, I'm going to get away with this. This is going to happen for me.
Now he does all the thing on shaving again. Shaving will be done every third day and includes underarms, legs, and pubic area, navel to anus. All areas are to be completely shaven every Saturday. You are to use the wall clippers with a guard no greater than 1/2 an inch. And then present yourself to me for measurement checks.
Jesus, this guy has a fucking he has an endorsement deal.
Yeah. Toe jam, clip him
above your vaginal slit. You can have a rectangular patch.
Is hair allowed in the asshole? Why? Because I'm too hairy, sir.
Is that a hair on your anus? Go ahead and shave it. They're paying for it.
Yeah, yeah. She's shaving it. You fuck it.
She gets her menstruation.
What is your major malfunction?
Above your vaginal slit, you can have, one, a rectangular patch that must have be centered above your vaginal slit. It will have a length of no greater than 3/4 inch of length of your vaginal slit, no wider than 1 inch.
1 inch.
Number two, any other shape or design that is centered above your vaginal slit with an area no greater than that of an
equilateral
triangle with the height of 3/4 of the length of your vaginal slit, or three, comply with the total clean shaven, regardless of which choice of shave. Noncompliance is based on a number two rate.
Of course it is. Why would he even write
and
this so obvious?
And he has his GBD points, but we don't have to get into that.
Just legally, you got to cover yourself.
Sleepwear.
Yeah. Sleepwear. I will select your sleepwear for you, and you will find it under your pillow. If there is none, when you then you are to be naked.
Dude, this guy, I'm sorry to interrupt, this guy's a control freak.
Let's read the rest of it before we make a conclusion like that, Jimmy. The guy, he's organized. I think he's
exactly. Leaves no detail.
Right. Why leave it open for some broad to make decisions for herself, make you unhappy?
That's true. He's basically like Felix Unger if he were a rapist.
Right. You are to have your sleepwear on within 20 minutes after the kids are in bed. This pertains to any time we are alone as a family, whether or not I am home or in bed with you, and whether or not we are at home. You are to have your sleepwear on within 20 minutes? I thought
she was supposed to be naked. He's fueled up right now.
It's coming out of his
balls.
She's
supposed to be naked if he didn't leave anything.
Oh, these are under the circumstances if it's under a pillow.
Her sleepwear is under the pillow.
Yeah.
If it's nothing under the pillow, then it's naked night.
Dude, he has to stop jerking every 3 minutes because he's going to splooge.
He is just ready to pop.
He's just working it.
Wait to get to the last page. Respond, a cunt. He's like frothing at the mouth.
If there is someone else staying with us, or we are staying with someone else, then you are to be naked at the time we go to bed, regardless of what was selected. During your menstrual cycle, you can wear a top and panties. The top is to be no longer than that to cover your butt cheeks. That's it. Here we go. Fellatio, intercourse, and other sex acts. Fellatio must be at least 5 minutes and may include climax. Intercourse includes anal and vaginal intercourse. Sex acts can be oral, anal, or vaginal and include, but are not limited to, stripping, hand jobs, fingering, masturbation, dildoing, vibrators, and object insertion. All application of lubes to myself, you, or any object will be done by you.
See, this is what happens in a contract. It gets mixed up in all this legal mumbo-jumbo.
All right, let me tell you how important...
You got to read the GBDs on this one.
Yeah, let me tell you how important the GBDs are as far as the sex goes. Legal mumbo-jumbo.
This is why you have a lawyer. You can't make heads
or tails. Whereas... Who there to dildoing and vibrators.
You know what I like here? I just noticed is the headings. I like the fancy lettering, like it's a fairy tale.
He's found some fonts.
Once upon a time, there was a rapist.
Yeah, he's found some interesting little fonts.
Yeah.
The GBDs for the sex acts. GBD, 14 GBD points will be given for anal intercourse not expected.
I want to say that's 19.
It might be 19.
It could be. It looked like a 4. Okay, 19. Okay. Wow, even more.
How do you define not expected? He takes it or she offers it?
She offers it.
I think she gets on all fours, turns around and goes, fuck me in the ass.
But it doesn't happen that way. While he's in her vag, she probably goes, put it in my ass.
You think?
Yeah, of course.
I wouldn't give her 19 for that kind of lackluster attitude.
Oh, I would. He's so gone.
You know what, Jim?
Point.
You were phoning it in.
Yeah, phoned it in.
You lost all GBDs.
You lost all your GBDs.
Yeah, maybe she has to do a little acting. All right.
7 GBDs for anal intercourse expected. That's why I was thinking it was 14. It's double the GBDs if it's unexpected. Yeah. 3 per fellatio to ejaculation. 1 for each not expected. 3 per week for expected. I guess that's just sex.
Yeah.
It's a total of 33 points.
No, that one, that blowjob not expected, that's the Goodfellas moment in the kitchen.
Oh, that's it?
Yeah,
right.
She goes shopping.
Yep.
She could really pile up the GBDs in that section right
there.
Yeah,
absolutely. The sex things are piling.
One bottle of Jack, she'll have a fucking month to herself. Not this nudge.
Nudge. Birthdays and anniversaries. Well, this sounds sweet.
Yeah.
On your birthday, January 4th, you will receive 1 GBD that is good only on your birthday. On or before my birthday, you will select and purchase a sex toy for yourself. This will be considered my birthday gift from you. On or before our anniversary, you will select or purchase new lingerie for yourself. Lingerie may include a cameo and panty set, nice nylons and garter set, corset, baby doll set, a costume bra and panty set, etc. Lingerie does not include nightgowns or PJs. The lingerie that you selected and purchased will be your sleepwear for that night.
Hmm.
Photos.
Photos.
Just about done here, kids.
You are to pose for 20 photos per quarter on demand unless your quota is filled. Outfits, toys, and poses will always be chosen by me. You must be freshly shaven on the day the photos are taken, regardless of your shaving schedule. You will also style hair, apply makeup, and nail polish as needed. All photos are done in sets no less than 5. You have a quota of 1 set per month. Oh, she's got to do a set of photos per month. Wow, there must be a lot of pictures of this broad. And more GBDs given out. Quarterly
wordly.
Negotiation.
This is it, the last
quarterly
section.
Negotiation.
It's like when you get one of those Parker Brothers games that's like too involved. You just say, the inside box.
Yeah.
You just like, you know what? Fuck this
game. Let's just say.
Let's go play Monopoly again.
You get the money for free parking.
Let's go play Sorry.
It's not in the rules.
Yeah, really. Let's just.
You will not wear fullback panties. You will not wear pantyhose. I will teach you.
quarterly negotiation. By the first day of each quarter, you must choose how to keep track of your GBDs. You can either be given actual paper GBDs that you are responsible for returning to be redeemed, or you can choose to have them tracked on a computer. By the end of the first day of each quarter, you are to choose your pet name that you want me to call you by. Your choice must meet my approval, and noncompliance will be a 20 GBD loss.
Uh-oh.
20 GBD loss. Wait a minute. She's got to come up with a name.
If he doesn't like the name,
he doesn't like the name,
he just gets rid of 20 GBDs.
That's how she loses all the GBDs. Oh, yeah. She
for
makes up
anal.
For ass sex. This guy's a genius.
Yeah, this
come
is...
up with a name. Your ass sex queen. No,
nope.
Don't like it.
Minus 20.
Minus
Try
20.
Try again.
Try again.
Cupcake.
This is the sexual loan shark where you just once you get in with them, you're never able to pay him
this
back.
This is his banking fees for the ATM.
You know,
she's trying to get the GD. and you just hit it at a strip club where it's like 10 bucks to take out 10.
As most non-legal minds, you're all misreading this contract.
All right, Jimmy,
it's
please.
It's embarrassing.
Jimmy Norton Esquire, could you please...
What he says here, and your choice must meet my approval, and non-compliance will be a 20 GBD loss. He does not say for the suggestion you take the loss. He is saying for non-compliance.
But, dude, there's a gray area here. Gray area here. By the end of the first day of each quarter, you must choose your pet name that you want me to call you by. Your choice must meet my approval. And non-compliance will be 20 GBD loss.
Right.
So he can say, obviously, it seems as if her not coming up with a name is non-compliance and will cost 20 GBD.
Or by not changing it.
But he can turn this into, at any time of his choosing, that if he doesn't like it, it is also non-compliance.
Does say your choice.
It's in the same paragraph. Your choice must meet my approval.
Counselor?
Non-compliance is about not coming up with a name or not changing it. Maybe it's written in a gray area way, but it's not about coming up with a name Because that's too much gray area. Nobody would sign that contract. It would be silly.
Yeah.
Well, that, you know something? Let's leave that to the lawyers to argue
that's
about
right.
For years. For years.
Believe me. Well, a lot of people think that Ginsburg will go one way mm-hmm. and Thomas another, you know, because Breyer is
you
very
know,
predictable with this
I
stuff.
Remember Frey versus Frey, the vaginal or anal intercourse.
No, it's more like I remember Jefferson versus alleged slave lover.
This is not a contract.
Hmm.
It is a description of rules for you. You can, within 2 weeks prior to the end of the quarter, request a change. If you request a change before that time, you will lose 10 GBDs. Negotiations requested in a timely manner will be done after you are in your sleepwear. All properly made requests will be considered. Changes made will be explained at the beginning of the next quarter. So she does have a chance to negotiate. That is
wow,
brilliant. This should be posted online, to be printed out, and taken home by every gentleman.
As a great man once said, if she shaves her clit, you must acquit.
Let's go to Clown Raper. Clown Raper.
That's not his real name, Opie.
Clown Rapper.
Rapper. I like Clown Raper myself, but all right, okay. Clown Rapper, what's up?
This guy is not the genius that we think he is. There's no fatty clause. Where is the fatty clause?
Oh, a weight gain clause. God damn.
Excellent point.
Subsections. This is like the. You know what this is like, though? This is like our own constitution. This is like our constitution.
You need some amendments.
You start it.
You got to start somewhere.
We the people.
Right.
But I think he covers it.
And then you kind of add amendments to the whole thing. A fatty amendment.
What do you think? Bill thinks it's covered. I don't know.
This is how he covers it. For any sort of noncompliance, he takes away the GBDs. He ties her to the bed. She can't eat. So she put on, 2-3 pounds. You just leave her there for a couple of days.
Okay. That's right. So in this contract, he has ways to keep her thin.
You feed her dry wheat toast for 3 days. Good point.
Let's go to Eric in Tennessee.
And then if she continues to complain, you can bang her in the ass the rest of the week.
Eric, what's up?
She can't
Hey, boys, I'm getting married in 6 months. Can you send me a copy of that?
Yeah, where can people get a copy of this? Because everyone's asking for a copy so they can check it out on their own.
RichVoss.com. Bonnie actually made Rich sign it.
We might have it linked up on opianthony.com. Let's say hi to Stacy in Baltimore. Stacy, what's up?
Hey, I just want to call bullshit on this whole thing with this chick because, personally, I think, she's just an ultra-submissive chick. She got into this relationship with this guy who's apparently super dominant, and the two of them did this together because they're both really kinky and into it. And now, the relationship's gone sour, and she's like, oh, my God, he treated me so badly. I just believe it's bullshit.
All right.
Oh, so you're saying he didn't kidnap her?
No way.
Yeah, it's a real story. You can go to the smoking gun to check out the contract for yourself. Natasha, what's up? Miami.
Hi. I love this idea. I can't wait to download it for my husband.
Wow. You really like this?
Yes. Actually, I can't believe he didn't think of this.
Why?
Are you a sub?
Yes.
Good girl.
Ooh, so you would sign something like this?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think... When we were dating, he was much more controlling, and I loved it. And now he's, getting a little bit afraid of me, and I don't like it at all.
Do you like your hair pulled?
Oh, yeah. Well, that's nothing.
No, of course it's not. What do you mean? Like, nipple clamps you like? Your face slapped?
Yeah, what's the craziest thing you do there?
Craziest thing? Well, he once really kind of hurt me when he, put... clothespins on my nipples and did me up the ass at the same time. That was a little much, but...
Broke a little sweat there?
Does he bite you?
Oh, yeah, he likes to bite.
On your back and stuff, right?
Oh, yeah, everywhere.
How about being choked?
No, I'm not really into that too much.
Oh, no decent girl.
We tried that, actually.
Jimmy's going into a trance.
No, I just wanted
anyone else notice that?
His desk is
how about choking
up over here.
No, I have to pee. I couldn't get a rod right now if fucking I had to.
How about a suffocation with a pillow?
I'm not into that either.
What about locking you in a trunk for 2 hours?
How about if I fuck you in the mouth and pinch your nose? That's hardcore.
All right. Natasha, thank you.
Bye. You're a good girl.
Yes. Let's say hi to Turtle from Whackbag. Turtle.
Hey, guys, I live in Iowa, and this guy is absolutely a visionary, but he's being condemned by the local papers and the television. They're calling him a sexist, misogynist, you know, just basically asshole. But
goose.
I think he's a visionary.
The reality, yeah, he's ahead of his time. We're not ready for this. Yeah.
Exactly. They thought that Galileo was a kook, and all these other people. Turns out they weren't.
Let's go to Jerry in Pennsylvania. Jerry.
Hey, I just wanted to comment on that, man. Sounds like a work contract to work for Howard Stern.
That's pretty good, actually. Thank you.
All right, man, later.
All right. We haven't taken a break in a very long time.
I got to piss.
Yeah, I got to take a leak already.
A little tease here. Heather in Minnesota, what do you got for us after the break?
I'm just calling about my little show last night. This is Two Bugs.
And Jimmy told you to call?
Yeah, Jimmy told me to call.
All right. This girl, Heather, she got crazy on Pal Talk last night, and she's calling in to tell us all about it. Right? What the hell happened there?
Hello?
That's even more bizarre.
Heather?
She's back on hold. I have no idea how that happened, but we still have Heather from Minnesota.
What room was she in, Jimmy?
It might have been it was one of the Opie and Anthony fan rooms.
Because I couldn't even get into the goddamn Opie and Anthony fan room last night.
I always can.
There was 250 people in there, so it peaked out. And I was trying to get in, and it kept saying, the room is maxed. The room is maxed out.
You need to get more memory on your computer. That's what the problem is.
No, it's not.
I'm telling you, no.
Stop using dial-up.
What's Pal Talk?
What is this? What are they doing with the curling?
You don't even want to know, Anthony.
They've taken out a giant compass.
They're measuring to see who's closest to the bullseye.
Is that it? And the guy throws the red thing out?
That's why that's not in a bar. How much do you think that compass cost?
$15,000.
It's got to be a few bucks, yeah.
Perhaps more than that, Hope.
It's got to be calibrated by a professional calibrating guy.
All right, listen.
What do you do for a living? I calibrate the curling compasses.
The curling compass.
You just got to get some more RAM. Where's the, in the hard drive thing?
The RAM in the hard drive.
Yeah, load it right in the side of it.
Bill Burr's a blithering idiot when it comes to computers.
I know a lot about him. I used to work at CompUSA.
Jimmy Pissoff? What's the record? A minute 57?
Whatever it is, but I'll have one with you.
All right,
Kyle.
I'm going for the record today.
Right, we're doing the same urinal too. Helmet to helmet, two men fighting it out.
Remember our contract, Jimmy. Will hold my cock when I piss, and unless otherwise instructed.
And you will make the yummy noise whenever it's presented to you.
Non-compliance is loss of 20 GBDs
and all mic privileges.
Rich Voss joins the program next. A big anniversary for Rich Voss. We'll explain next. Stay there. It's Whip 'Em Out Wednesday on the Opie and Anthony program today. Want to know more about WOW? Go to opieandanthony.com. We got to say hi to Rich Voss.
Hey, what's happening?
He has joined the program.
You know, Bonnie and I have a contract, too. I won't drool on her, and she won't fuck people that say she's funny. That's where she draws the line. That wasn't bad. To open up, you know,
As an opener?
As an opener?
No, it gave you somewhere to go.
Yeah, it's true.
You can build.
You can build. Can I tell you a quick story real quick?
Oh, God, yes.
No, it's not even a... You know,
I said,
I take a little abuse on Whackbag, this and that, but this time I really deserve this. I was doing an audition yesterday with Wee Man from Jackass.
Oh, God.
And he has bigger hands than me. I put my hands next to him.
Oh, my God. I swear
to God. So when they call me midget fingers or midget hands, they're right.
They're very correct. Hey, it's Voss.
We had a pee off during the break.
Yep.
The old record was a minute 57 by good old Jimmy Norton.
Jimmy Norton.
No, Jim baby-ass Norton.
Yeah, baby-ass Norton, who loves showing his ass off to everybody.
He's got a baby's ass on a grown man.
My nickname in the mob was Doll Cheeks. That's what they called me.
It's a child's ass.
Certainly is.
Old record, a minute 57.
Uh-huh.
I went in there and did 2 minutes and 33 seconds.
2:33.
To set a record that only lasted for 7 seconds because Jim Norton still holds the record.
Wow.
Longest pee at 2 minutes and 40 seconds.
And it was a real pee. I don't cheat. I didn't stop. When I have to piss that, because I on planes, I'm flying the aisle. I piss constantly. It's like every time, I can't even get it out of all one. It's my breathing. It's all like... If I breathe a certain way, it almost like opens like the Get Smart gate.
You're an athlete.
More has to come.
You've taken home urinal gold.
And plus, when he pisses that long, he has an excuse to sit in a rest area. I'm peeing. I'm peeing.
Believe me, it's only part of my strategy. When I kept looking over at you, going, psst.
It's just, yeah.
He comes in with a little squirt gun in the rest
it's
area.
It's just harder to take a leak when those lips are looking through that round circle. Psst, buddy. Ugh.
Hey, Al Lewis, hold on. I'm really using it this time.
Do you ever go to the pee, when you go to the pee booth, you remember the guy, do you ever get notes thrown over at you? Like the little notes that come over to
these guys.
Dude, years ago I got that. I haven't gotten that. I haven't gone to the pee shows anymore, but years ago. I was
guys
fucking,
throwing notes over the
yeah,
top.
Dude, yeah, I was top, J-Lo in a thong in fucking peep shows. You've never seen a more delicious sight than me in a Jersey peep booth. They were all over me.
We went to a place in Philly or something. I got kicked out. Were you with us or was it Florentine? That I got kicked out of the peep booth because I was trying to talk him down in money. And
Christ.
Trying to Jew him down, Rich. Just say it.
Could you just pay the price for once?
How do you get thrown out of a... Ugh.
Yeah.
People.
Hey, we got to get to Heather. By the way, we were talking about Pal Talk and Vosko's What's Pal Talk?
What's Pal Talk?
I got MySpace.
Yeah, I'm on MySpace. MySpace, it's great to have, but it's, you know.
Sure.
You got to step up now to Pal Talk.
MySpace, Jim Norton.
Yeah.
Yeah, but
MySpace, Anthony Cumia.
Yeah, right. You spell that. Jim Norton.
Who's leading in that, by
C-U-M-I-N.
The way? Who has more friends? Well,
Jimmy still has more friends.
Why?
I'm right behind you guys, though.
I've sent out money, and they knew I would send out money.
Jimmy never sends out money. He's lying. Shut up.
I send out $50
you don't send anything out.
And a $3,000 gift certificate.
I'm the independent candidate in this
yeah,
place.
Yeah, yeah. How many friends you have?
Me? I have close to 8,500.
8,500.
That's a respectful
that's
number.
That's cute.
I went
15,000.
Yeah, I got about 13,000.
Oh,
when I was in
sweet.
Your top eight, I was getting like 100 a day friends.
Yeah.
All right, the second I dropped out of your top eight, it's like, you know, 45
I'll
or whatever.
I'll hook you up.
Huh? You can put me in your top eight?
I won't, though. How many do you have?
I got like 55, which isn't bad.
55 got, friends?
5,500.
Oh. 5,500.
And
we all pale to Dane.
That's the big war, though, with like comics. Kevin Hart. He gets on MySpace and he goes, put me in your top eight, man. So I put him in my top eight, and he had me in his top eight. And that son of a bitch, I go back 3 days yeah. later, he buried me into the middle of his friends.
I
he was sucking off all my friends. So I said, fuck it, I buried him. He
Dane
begged
Cook,
me.
Dane Cook actually has Rhode Island.
Yeah, he does. He's got like, how many does he have? 800?
894.
Oh, at this point, he's probably
894,000. Probably over a million.
John in Ohio. John?
Yes.
What's up?
Well, I had a comment about your piss contest.
Okay.
All right.
More accurately, I think you should go for volume.
Because I don't know what Jimmy was doing over there. I don't know if he was just dribbling for a while or what.
Sometimes you do dribble. It's part of like you're like you dribble a little bit, then you piss hard. It's just the way it flows out.
All right, next contest. Yeah. Cheat. Next contest, we line up the water bottles. We're going for pure volume
and go for
right.
both time and
Professor
volume.
Professor Anthony ought to have a graduated cylinder.
No, 'cause I'll force it out.
A graduated cylinder.
Yeah, we're going with volume next pee contest.
I'm completely for that.
Well,
all right.
And as far as volume goes, I've done 33 to 34 ounces.
I don't know what that means, sir.
That's got to be a couple water bottles, I'm thinking.
You think of what a 40 is like, you know?
All right. Good idea, John.
Sweet.
It's all about the CD-ROM, you know? You just get one of those in there. Dude, you know nothing.
Let's move to Heather in Minnesota. She's been waiting on hold for about, 45 minutes here. Heather, Minnesota.
Stop.
We're getting back to you. So you were on Pal Talk last night?
Yeah.
Yep.
And?
Yeah, I did a little show for everybody.
You did a little show on Pal Talk?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Well,
I only saw a part of it. I didn't see the whole show. I saw a part.
I was doing a show for Jimmy. He's a funny-looking one.
Yeah.
All these guys were sending me instant messages, and they're saying, you got to go over and see this girl.
Yeah.
Oh, Pal Talk.
They were going crazy over by the lake on Pal Talk.
And the next thing you know, she's putting her pussy in a wood chipper. I went over to her room and I what's your name on Pal Talk? Toots?
Tootbug.
Tootbug.
Not a window I would ever open, by the way. I would never open someone with that name. I think it was a guy.
And what room are you in?
The main room, I think.
Opie and Anthony fan. Yeah. And then what kind of act were you doing?
I did a little while and then showed my little landing strip, and then pulled out the pink dildo, and then my boyfriend joined me for the end.
I didn't see the end. I saw her. She has a nice meaty one, by the way. She was using the dildo on herself, and I even heard some audio. You had the audio on at one point, didn't you?
Yeah.
It was really, really...
Off and on. It wasn't working too good.
Was she going, oh...
You couldn't hear it, no, because you couldn't see her face. It was just a crotch shot.
Oh, yeah.
And what did it sound like? It sounded like Jimmy Stewart eating applesauce is what it sounded like. It was just like very sexy. I didn't see the boyfriend part. I missed the sex.
Oh, you missed the best part of it then.
Well, yeah, I know.
Do you spank it to these to these girls?
No, I don't. I circle biblical passages. Stupid. I spank it when they're fully dressed and crying about a dead relative.
It's all about a lot of the pal
talk. If she has a pussy and a computer, I'm jerking off.
A lot of the pal talk is about hooking up. There are conversation rooms, but then there's an adult section. And you click on that, and there's a bunch of rooms of things like, let me pull up some name rooms for you over here. Go to rooms.
Yeah, click on the hard drive.
Adult. Shut up. And a playground. All right. Orgasms Are Us, Multicam, and Oral. There are 350 people in there. iPorn Perverts, Pervets, Flicks and Cams. Ladies Making Men Hard.
Ooh.
We Like to Be Watched. Anal Sex and Porn Videos. BBWs, Big Beautiful Women, No Rules.
Ugh, there should be nobody in that room. Just five
bisex.
Cows.
Five cows grazing. Yeah. Bisex orgy. Hardcore anal pee fetish extremes. And then you pop on to these rooms. Let's say, guys, you're going to lose the sound for a minute because I'm going to punch one of these rooms up. Let's see. See these cams? Now let me pop a couple up. Look. There's someone with a foot up someone's ass.
Oh, my God.
Quite literally.
Oh, up a dude's ass. That's nuts hanging down.
Up a guy's ass.
No, that's a hand. That's a hand.
Wow. No, that's a foot. It's a hand? It looks like a knee.
That's a foot up to the heel.
That's a knee up to the heel.
Jesus. That is fucking...
No. Is it or is it an arm...
Oh, it's an arm.
Dude, what is it?
It's a
leg.
No, it isn't.
Because here's another leg.
No, it isn't.
It doesn't look like Norton has a baby ass there.
It's
a foot.
Hand. It's a fucking hand.
Look, it's coming out. It's a foot, you idiot.
Oh, my God.
Jimmy, look, it's a foot.
It's a hand.
Jimmy, it's a foot.
It's a foot.
That is a foot.
Oh, look at the exit wound. Look at the exit wound.
Oh,
he just sucked it back in. Look, it's moving like a horse's ass every time. Takes a shit.
Get out of here.
Oh my God.
Oh, shut it off. Shut it off. Shut the fucking thing off.
That guy just got a foot up his ass.
What is that? Is bleeding?
Holy shit.
Shut it off.
I can't take it.
Shut it off.
Holy shit.
It looks like a volcano that's about to erupt.
Oh,
it's
just
bubbling and ready
awful.
To go.
That was horrid.
I can't wait to get on that site tonight.
Oh, my God.
That's worth putting a camera in your room.
Oh, wow.
So run out there and get your cameras, everybody, because...
That was horrid.
Not only was it a funny ass, it was acrobatic. Like, he did it backwards, and, like, I mean, that was fucking...
Yeah, there was a technique to it.
Yeah. Was standing there with the back toward the ass, and then bent the leg at the knee and shoved the foot up the ass from behind.
What's next, a horse?
I know, I was going to say. Like,
I'll look for
horse.
That room. There's probably
you know what's great about
there.
These webcams? They were invented, so maybe you could have a little conference call with your office worker.
That's how it's presented when it's first thought up.
Hey,
they go, you know
we got this great idea for business.
You know, how many times have we...
L.A. and I'm in New York. We don't have to fly anymore.
You can hold up that pie chart.
Right. Bob, how many times have we flown to Tokyo to take a meeting?
Right.
Now we can get on something, video conferencing. From my computer, I can look at our contract with Wang over there, and then like 10 minutes after that, if a chick's on the other end, I could jerk off to this.
Right.
Get on it.
Wait, you don't think it was pitched like that in the big meeting? Like, look, my friend puts his foot in his friend's asshole, and I'm always listening to it on the phone. I don't believe him.
Well, we'll get back to you about this. What kind of money allocation are you looking for?
Even better. There's a lot of married couples that are listening to this program right now, and I would maybe it works both ways. One of the people in the marriage there had to like talk the other, you know, their significant other into the pal talk thing. Going, look, no, I need the webcam because you know I want to keep an eye on the shop.
Right.
Like,
put it
was,
in the shop.
I want to know some of the real reasons you use to get the webcam in your house.
Legitimate reasons.
Because you know damn well, you know, guys are like, oh, fuck.
Well,
when she goes to bed, I can check out other girls. Blah,
I want to know how you
but
guys
But how am
just...
I going to get the webcam installed without her being on to me here?
How are you guys just nonchalantly riffing now after you just fucking
yeah.
said it?
I don't want to hear
if
it.
If I don't talk, my fucking heart, I will never go down.
Opie's going to have a bowl of cereal in about 3 minutes.
Yes. We've seen it all.
Red ones with like little fucking like a Frankenberry.
You know what? Give me the Cocoa Puffs. I'm ready here.
Strawberry filled
like
Cheerios.
I would like to maintain a certain level of innocence. Jesus.
I almost threw up when I saw that.
That was really
that
funny.
Red bloody ass.
I have favorite spanking targets, like girls that you talk to in the rooms. I will just jack watching chicks. They have no idea that I'm fucking watching them and jacking. It's the greatest thing ever.
There are other rooms though. There's a room called Help. Which is empty.
Help, I got a foot in my ass.
Yeah, maybe that guy should have been in Help.
And then you chat to the guy, Help, I saw it.
Friends, Love, and Romance. That, I guess, is where people are looking for the above. Friends, Love, and Romance. There's Divorced, Flirting, Gay, International, Just Friends, 20s and 30s, 40s and 50s, Seniors, Teens. There's that you can get social issues and politics.
Teens,
people get in there.
You're just playing Russian roulette there. Yeah. You go into that fucking room.
Well, let's pop on teens. What's in there?
That's some fresh faced FBI agent in a wig.
There are 49. There are 49 people in the bored teens party room.
Yeah,
let's click
and one's
on
a
that.
Teenager.
You're gonna lose the.
Let's say hi.
Close one of your open groups before trying to enter another.
Dangerous. Creep. Let's do that tomorrow.
I have to close foot up the ass room in order to get in.
Oh, come
that's
on,
too bad.
Ant. That's also the Dr. Scholl's meeting room.
In the morning.
No, what is that awful commercial? Are you gelling? That guy's ass was gelling.
All right, find that. Let's go to John in Connecticut. John?
Hey, guys. I went out and got Pow Pow because you were talking about it, and I have not once made it to an Opie and Anthony room because I can't get past all the naked chicks. I just spend my time sitting there waiting for these chicks to show their tits, and I have not once made it to the Opie and Anthony room.
Dude, I have jacked to every chick in the O&A rooms when they have something, like some of them will flash. Like Lucci will flash, or a couple other girls will flash, and I'll jack. But I like to jack when they're just talking, because there's just something really creepy about
it. Never,
wow, is that creepy.
You'll never put your dick on there, like, so people
no,
can know.
Stupid.
No.
No.
And you just, some of the chicks are just teases, but you sit there for, like, hours waiting for these girls
exactly.
to do something.
Exactly.
Teases.
Takes there. Over your life. Look, he stopped going to the gym. Yeah.
No, I've
Jim.
Been going more so I can put the cam on my stomach and dick eventually.
Oh, there are.
I'm sick and tired of flashing the TV.
Wait,
for the
you
fucking
don't want to blend in with the rest of them with their beer guts and fucking jerking their cocks?
No.
There are rooms where you go in and it's like ladies looking for men. And you go there, there's not one woman to be found. Every camera you click on is some fucking Arab animal sitting there jerking off.
Yeah, that's
I know. It's hot.
I love the guy. No. You ever see the guys who jerk off under the desk? It's like you have a camera angle. The guy puts it on the floor, and you just see his hand going back and forth. It's the creepiest slash thing I did when I was in L.A. Fucking angle.
Oh, no.
You bet I did.
Let's go to Wilson.
I'm spanking it.
Let's Jim Norton.
Let's check out Cleveland today. Wilson, what's up?
Hey, what's going on, fellas?
Hey.
Just calling, yeah, I had to tell my wife. I'm like, me and my buddies, we play this video game online, so we got to cheat, and that's how we use the camera. Yeah, sure.
Oh, there you go.
And I thought it was because of you guys.
Creep.
Do you know who I jacked to yesterday, and I'll give it up because she doesn't care. You know Kara? She called in one day and did some dirty shit. I don't think she's on right now, but she did some dirty shit. I fucking jacked watching her yesterday.
Really?
Yeah, she's lovely.
Kaya?
You look at her on the camera and just start jacking?
Like an animal. Happy typing girl won't flash, but we're trying to get her to
she's
show
like,
her breasts. She's actually a nice girl. It
working bugs me. Nice girl, yeah.
Yeah.
Let's go to Kaya, Kia, Kiana. What's your name, bro, from Whackbag?
Hey, it's Kai from Whackbag.
Hey, Kai, what's up?
Hey, dudes. Pal Talk damn near destroyed my marriage about 2.5 years ago.
Yeah, explain, please. Yeah.
Is that a semicolon or a period?
It's a semicolon, okay. Jimmy. Now, I was on all the time, 8-9 hours a day, meeting women all left and right. You know, I used to drive over the road and I'd meet up with them.
Just to say hi.
Well, if you're meeting up with them, it's not over pal talk. It's over meeting up with girls. I love that.
Yeah.
You know, the telephone almost ruined my marriage. I called up this chick, hooked up with her, and fucked her in a hotel room. That fucking telephone. Let me tell you. Let me tell you about the time a dime almost got me put in jail for murder.
Let's say hi to Mark in Michigan. Mark?
Hey, I just wanted to tell you guys, Yahoo used to have that same thing about, I don't know, 6-8 months ago. And they don't have it anymore. They had all these fucked up rooms where they had guys self-fucking each other and all this other shit, and they had all kinds of freaky-ass shit like that.
Yeah.
And how did you enjoy it?
Can they tell
me? I didn't watch. I mean, I watched a little bit of the self-suck shit, but that was about it. I was clicking on. They had, like, white girls crave black cock and all this other shit on there.
Did he say self-suck?
Yeah.
Self-suck?
Can they tell what room you're in?
Wait, let me translate. Voss wants to know, if he sneaks into a gay room, will anybody be able to catch him?
I'm just punching out, guys.
He's going to be, you won't find him under R. Voss. You'll find him under Funny Dope in a...
What the hell's that?
Oh.
Oh, I just punched up a MySpace thing from a girl that I think Jimmy jacked off to. Is that her?
Carrie, yeah.
She doesn't give...
Because everyone on MySpace has to have fucking music. Enough with the music, all right? Enough with the soundtrack to your life.
Are there any more pictures there or no? I want to see more pictures.
No, I can't take the music
but
on
no,
MySpace.
The music goes off when you hit more pictures, you little doll.
Shut up.
How long is this pal talking
I like
around?
The hacky bio that the chicks have on there. I'm into real people. If you're not real, then just fucking move on, because I don't have time for that shit, man.
Shut
the fuck up.
I have time.
We've talked about things like the music and the bio and the pictures, the angle. And the eye, where you just see the girl's eye, and
well,
there's a lot of
giving
eye
the
makeup
finger
on.
Like you're some sort of badass, and like everybody has that at this point.
Well, or lips, how they hide that they're a fat.
Yeah,
pig,
and you go to more pictures, and it's just them all blown up.
Well, they only do from the neck up.
Yeah, see, there's
going
to be a problem.
They have a picture holding up a newspaper with a date on it,
yeah,
so you
do
know.
That too.
Hold up with a date, so we know that you're not fat anymore.
Or they're fucking standing on a beach, but they're like 400 yards away. Like it was taken with who took that fucking the Hubble or the Gotti surveillance team? You fat cunt! you think you're fooling with that? You're floating over the Super Bowl, you fat pig.
Let's go to Sonny Farrelly. Sonny.
Hey, guys, what's happening?
Good to hear from you, Sonny.
Sonny's been a plug whore all day on Pal Talk. He keeps wanting to put up links.
What's up?
No, I'm not putting up any links. I'm just letting people know where to go.
Hi, sweetie.
Hey, listen, I got Pal Talk, obviously, and I'm married. But, see, I made my wife sign a contract.
Yeah, sure you did.
Yeah, I did.
You wanted a big laugh on that.
Nice one, Sonny.
Okay, all right.
So AOL paid like $500 million for MySpace.
Yeah.
How much do you think they'll pay for Pal Talk?
I think Fox bought it for $750 million.
What?
For MySpace? MySpace, yes.
Yeah, let's go. Brian in Michigan. Brian?
I think.
Shitfoot.
A little late, but he got it
shit
in.
Shitfoot! Shitfoot! Oh,
that is hilarious. And that was actually Heather Mills doing it. So what a balancing act.
One more. BCH.
Nothing? Oof.
Hey, BCH.
Boy, did that bomb.
What's
I thought I'd get a nice laugh.
I wasn't listening.
I said it was Heather Mills doing it. So what a balancing act.
All right. Now that's funny. Heather Mills.
Shitfoot.
I was just thinking of the fucking money that guy made.
$750 million.
Seinfeld, writing brilliant scripts 10 fucking
years.
What's
up, Obi? Yeah.
What's up?
Gets $500.
Something I've discovered, as crazy and fucking cringy and outlandish as you think fucking ONF fans are, Pal Talk is the only place where they're the most normal fucking people in there.
Yep.
Yeah. It's incredible.
Because the other rooms are crazy.
Yeah, the other rooms are, you just saw. How long did it take me to punch up a foot up some guy's ass?
Yep.
It was seconds.
Longer I know, and it's like fucking 10:30 in the morning, even if he's on the East Coast.
Wait.
It was kind of weird, though. Anthony knew exactly where to go.
Absolutely.
I know how to navigate to the foot up the ass.
Let's point that out. Was that live or a video?
I couldn't tell.
Yeah, who knew?
Will you just give him the link so he can go in and
want the up
his stripper fake name?
Are you computer savvy at all?
No, I don't do that gross. I go on my.
I'm not talking about gross. I'm talking about do you know computers enough to download a program and run it?
not have Bonnie come over and help you.
Don't worry, Rich. It's not too addicting.
Yeah, an addictive personality.
Yeah, Rich is here because he's celebrating 20 years of sobriety.
20 years sober. We got to get him.
And now we're
just
turning
like
him
on
to Pal Talk, so it's his new addiction.
At least
it's
a round number on his act for a year. You know, you have a round number to do on for your act. For a year.
Oh, yeah. 20.
20 years, at least. Not like 17. Yeah, who cares? Oh,
congratulations. You know?
Thank you.
Bring in
thank
the
you.
Cake.
No one cared that I had 19 February 1st, but the fact that my friend
that's because it's not part of your fucking act.
Yeah, well, I don't say that every 3 seconds.
First of all, I don't do it that much in my act anymore.
I haven't eaten because you're drinking.
Huh?
And, Rich, we've brought a little cake for you.
Oh, that's fucking
happy
sweet.
Being clean for 20 years.
Look at that's fucking cool.
It's a crack pipe. It's a crack pipe cake.
Oh, that's fucking the best.
Get a picture before you fuck it up. We actually
pass it around and have everybody have a slice. We're bigger than U.S. Steel.
Then in the
if I see a gay Jew in Pal Talk, oh no, I have a partner.
You don't come to Pal Talk and talk to boss that way.
Mike, you don't come to Las Vegas and stick your foot in the asshole of a man like Mo Green like that.
Oh, that's cool.
Wow.
Ben and the guys got to, you know, get credit. They came up with this.
Good job, man.
It's an actual crack pipe cake.
What are the baker there, whatever the fucking guy is.
Enzo.
What is
for your father. For your crackhead comedian friend.
A big crack pipe for your father. For your, if you almost fell, didn't you?
Don Corleone.
Oh, that would have been great.
If he fell and broke his wrist and fucking went face first into
Hold
the cake.
Up and get a picture for the website, because that's too good. Get a picture, E-Rock. Get a nice picture.
We can't cut this. We got to save this.
Oh, yeah.
For what? It's food.
You're going to lacquer it?
Yeah, what are you going to do with it?
We're cutting it in 3 seconds, you goose egg. I'm starving.
I'm going to frame it so you can smash it.
What is
I'm
it?
I'm putting this in my bush thing.
What type of cake is it?
You can literally hear him spitting on the cake.
Chocolate cake?
It's a real cake. You can't
save
it.
Could you not talk over the cake if people are going to eat it?
Get the fucking cake away from this.
You need a fucking salad bar.
No, no.
Sneeze guard.
Do you know how to take a picture?
No,
he's trying to set up a nice picture.
No one's
for
ever
you.
Asked him.
Yeah.
All right, now.
Just smile.
E-Rock, not of the box. We want to get the cake.
You're spitting on it. Pass it around.
Pass it around.
Hey, can we get some plates and some knives in here? Will you fucking pumps?
You know, here's how we'll do it, though. Just cut the end here so we can keep the bowl, right?
You're not keeping the bowl. We're eating it. It's a cake.
It's a cake. It isn't a real crack pipe.
I had a tranny cake.
He really thinks that it's like something you could save. It's a real cake.
Hold on, I don't see
this would be hilarious if this actually ruined his sobriety, just singing this fucking thing and
just
eating
it. He's so close to the edge for 20 years that he goes out tonight and just, one rock.
What's the matter? You couldn't find a cake with like a fucking a booth hole and a mouth on the other end? And we'll give you that cake after you arrest.
Save it.
See, this makes it all worthwhile. All those,
20 years.
You know. No, I mean, coming into studio and having, you know, this thing. This is great.
Yeah.
I'm telling you.
Rich, don't try to have a touching moment on the show.
I'm
very happy for Voss. That's a
what,
tremendous
are you kidding
thing.
Me?
20 years. Seems like yesterday you were sucking dick for crack, right?
No, I mean, it's tremendous to be 20 years sober and still act like you have 90 days.
I'm fucking as dry as tumbleweed.
Yeah, you cut the first piece, Rich.
Mm-hmm.
We're having cake.
There it goes.
We're celebrating our friend's 20 years sober.
20 years without
with a crack pipe cake.
Is that 20 years with everything? Booze, drugs?
Drugs, everything. Not gambling's only about two
Opie,
years.
Opie, once
two
again,
years?
Saw your skills.
Yeah.
How you somehow spun out of foot up the ass to his sobriety.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, I get the end piece. Yay.
There you go.
Thank you. Fatso likes more frosting.
That's wonderful.
Ooh. Oh, this is fucking nice.
Mm.
Good cake.
It's laced with hash.
No.
Yeah, wouldn't that be good?
You can't do that.
Lace the fucking cake.
No.
Nope. Now that would be a joke.
Opie, what are you doing? Sober. That's not how you get the cake.
What did he do?
He smashed.
Oh, Opie, just punched the cake. Eat it off your hand now. That's what the foot looked like when it came out of that guy's ass.
I know. Nice. Oh, this is
I'll
good.
Get a slice of this.
Well, that was the intern's portion that just got punched.
Jesus, he smashed out like it was Paul Bond's face.
Do we have any paper towels? Congratulations,
Thank
Rich.
You. This is good shit, man.
It's good cake. I may have two pieces.
Ugh. You guys should eat closer to the mics.
Well, we can take a break as we cut up the cake.
Oh, I thought you were eating healthy, Billy.
I know.
Billy's outside in the morning. He's having tuna with lemon on it.
Well, Billy's working out, and I'm working out. We can have a piece of cake. Am I right or wrong, B?
Hey, anything in moderation.
That's right. Why don't we take a break? We'll
Double
continue
B.
with Rich
nickname.
Boss and his cake.
Rich, now, you got your 60th birthday coming up, right?
Everyone's getting a piece of Rich Voss's cake.
I had two pieces, Opie.
Save a piece.
Moderation.
I want to bring a piece of that down to the Helium Comedy Club in Philly this week. I'm going to bring a piece down.
Nice. Wow, who's that? Very nice. Very nice plug.
I am.
Rich Voss at Helium Comedy Club in Philly.
Yeah.
Brand new club down there in Philly. I don't. I'm going to be in
Albany with me at the Comedy Works at Albany.
Wait. You're going to be in Helium?
Yeah.
In Philly, Rich Voss? No, yeah. I'm not going
to. You know
there.
What the best thing about that Helium Comedy Club is? It's right down the street from Bananas in Hasbrook Heights.
Yeah, I'm gonna have no bananas. Oh. We have no bananas today.
It's the
this
song.
Weekend.
I'd rather walk on to the sound of that guy's foot being pulled out of the asshole.
You know there was a sound.
I listen. Yeah. Let's get the plugs in. Bill Burr, where are you going to be?
I'll be Bananas, Hasbrook Heights.
Very good.
Yes.
This Friday, Saturday.
We have no bananas today.
Jimmy's going to be in Albany.
Not important. I'm not here to plug. I'm here to have fun and entertain people.
That means you sold out. Congratulations.
No, I don't know if I did or not. Artistically, yes.
Fucking.
The Comedy Works in Albany.
Jimmy. And Rich Voss at Helium Comedy Club in Philly.
So we're surrounding the tri-state area. So that bald-headed guy that sells T-shirts doesn't know where to drive to. The one who drove 4 hours to see you on a gig you canceled.
Did he?
Yeah, he drove 4 hours. And he
All right, listen.
SUNY Delhi?
Yeah.
I couldn't help it. I was shooting Lucky Louie. What am I going to do? Not shoot my right or wrong, Double B?
You're right. You're right. Nathaniel came in here to tell us something. I would like him to tell everybody.
All right.
Live on the radio. Because it is too good. I'm not setting him up. This is really a good thing. Nathaniel?
With his riveting energy. Here we go.
All right, is this running?
Yes.
All right. I didn't want to steal his line. Danny is the star of a new advertisement on the 202 Network.
Really?
Yes, he's hawking some wares.
And what would the wares be?
Pretty sure it's boner cream.
Boner cream.
That means we're doing well with this radio show.
You know
the
something?
Boner cream advertising is coming in.
Once
this show
start
is
getting
blowing
the boner
up.
Cream.
Are you kidding?
No, it's a brand new sponsor.
Can we hear
sponsor.
This spot? Welcome. Let
you,
me hear.
Wait, did they pay you for the spot?
Oh, God. Jimmy.
Jesus.
Who Jimmy? Gets gaseous after two slices of cake?
I want...
He heard the word boner.
Oh.
He gets gaseous after he breathes.
Yeah. I haven't farted in the studio in a month.
I know, and
you
it's
have.
Been very nice.
I just get scared.
All right, let's listen to the new spot, Anthony. The new sponsor. It's some kind of boner cream.
Can your wife or girlfriend count on you to perform in the bedroom? Let's face it, you're not getting any younger, but that doesn't mean you shouldn't be having satisfying, pleasurable, intimate relations. And now with Maxiderm, you can. Maxiderm is not a pill and doesn't require a prescription. It's a cream that you or your partner can apply directly to the source of the problem.
You or Derek.
You'll feel the blood fill, creating a strong, vigorous reaction.
Ooh.
And Maxiderm's deeply penetrating formula will bring satisfaction to you and your partner. So what are you waiting for? If you call right now, we'll tell you how to get a month's supply absolutely free. So call and feel the difference. Try Maxiderm today, risk-free for 90 days. 1-800-560-6160. Don't let another weekend go by wishing you tried Maxiderm. Call Maxiderm right now at 1-800-560-6160. Your call is completely confidential. 1-800-560-6160.
Yeah, it better be.
That's 1-800-560-6160.
You know what I like
Individual
about it?
Individual results may vary.
Well,
this product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease. Mm.
The faster you apply it, the better it feels.
And Maxiderm doesn't work for anal sex. For that, you need tough actin to actin.
I fucking bought this stuff years ago to put on your dick to numb it so you wouldn't fucking shoot quick.
Right.
So I put it on, and I'm banging my ex-wife, right? I couldn't feel anything. I couldn't feel it. And it kept, for forever, I came out, my whole, I broke blood vessels in my dick. It was all black and blue from fucking so long.
Wow.
Because you can't feel it. It's completely numb.
It was a numbing agent?
How'd you stay hard?
Yeah. Huh?
How'd you stay hard?
Well, mentally, I was thinking, I'm fucking, so I'm staying hard. But you can't feel it, and it was just, you can get this shit anywhere.
Why don't you just think of baseball or your last set?
Ooh.
You know, just something. Nothing.
Last set. Jesus. It's just numbing. Ugh.
Wow.
Please. Fucking open mic or Billy jumps in.
Danny, that was a great delivery, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
Great read.
You didn't, you didn't give out the number enough times, though.
I didn't write the copy.
It was very believable.
Yeah.
Did you try the stuff?
No,
did they make you try the stuff?
Get a free sample?
No.
That'd be nice. Come in. Maybe a weekend we could pop up the Pal Talk camera. You, Derek, your balls. You could rub it on each other.
Yeah.
Sword fight in the
And then Steve can run in. I don't like the taste. He left, didn't he?
It's his birthday today.
Steve's birthday?
Yeah, we told him to go home and enjoy
himself.
How
old is he?
I think he's, I don't know.
He's probably upset he didn't get a cake.
Yeah, let's go to Mike in Philly. Mike?
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Hey.
Good. What a jacker. Boss, love you, man.
What?
The boss, love you, man.
Thank you.
Sorry, got a jacker in the room.
Hey, he's not even a big mule, so can't, it's not even fun to watch. It's just soft and oh, go ahead, you talk.
Because I'm sure what Mike has to say is so much funnier than what Jimmy was about to spew out.
No, that's fine. I was about to get to a big, long bit, but you go right ahead. What were you saying?
Just want to know, if you use that boner cream, does your hand get bigger, too?
Oh, that's old.
Oh, God, that old gag.
Way to go. Thanks for spoiling everything.
Let's go to Chester in Newburgh. Chester?
Hey, what's going on, fellas?
What's up?
Hi, Chet.
Hey. Oh, thanks. Okay. I just want to let you guys know that that's not really a good ad there, man. Because, like, a month's supply for some guys could actually last a lifetime.
Ooh.
Hey, come
but
on.
Seriously, folks,
try the veal. I'll be here all weekend.
Now, that wasn't that bad. What are you trying? You trying to say that some guys like just come quick?
No, you got to apply that shit every time you have sex. Some guys might last a lifetime with just one bottle of it.
Why? Because you're saying because a lot of guys are married, right?
No, he's saying sometimes you get. Wait. What were you saying?
You have to apply that stuff every time you have sex.
Right.
What stuff? The
cream.
The cream.
Yeah.
Yeah, just slow it down a little.
So if you apply it, every time you have sex, some guys it might last a whole lifetime.
So what you're saying is...
Because
they don't have a lot of sex?
But ooh. Because... Yeah, yeah,
no, guys, I blew it up.
No,
we want to... It's funny, I just want to understand it.
Yeah, you can't hang up now.
Why would he need it more?
Because, oh, God.
The wording wasn't clear, dude. That's all it is. I know the joke is decent. The wording wasn't clear.
Yeah, just be clear. Why would he need it more or less?
He doesn't have sex a lot. You're starting to make me forget my own joke.
No.
All right, calm down and start over.
Just start over.
Start over. Okay. Hey, guys. How's it going?
What's up, bro?
All right.
Okay.
Chester, whatever you need.
You know that Maxiderm stuff?
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, if you have to apply it every time you have sex.
Yeah.
Some guys might use a free subscription 1 month of it in a lifetime.
Well, see, you got to do it with more energy, like Billy or a Heffron type comic. Like, run around the stage, you know. Run around the stage for no apparent reason.
That's great.
You know.
Hold on a minute. Voss, who's hurt 8 minutes too late.
So, the reason.
I'll sit on a stool with my feet dangling off of it.
All right.
Wait.
Take it like a man.
The final reason was... That a lot of guys maybe don't enjoy sex with their wife. So,
guys.
Dude.
No, but is that what it is? Some guys don't enjoy sex with their wife, so it would last them a long time.
Yeah, hurry up and explain it, because we're coming back on air in like fucking 30 seconds.
Is that why?
Oh, I'm sorry. You know, can I just get a car crash and we can end this?
What? A what?
Hey, it's wrong.
My God, you did not know what you were missing. Holy shit, you should have hung up hours ago.
What a tool.
A complete idiot.
I'm going to break out one of the rare ones for him.
All right.
Wow.
What a dolt.
The last guy to get that was Joel Steinberg. Congratulations.
Jeremy from Jersey.
The Good finger. Good morning, shit dicks.
Go ahead, Jeremy.
Hey, maybe Danny's mom can let us know how that cream works out.
Oh, wow.
Oh, Danny, you can take that?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Danny's mom joke.
Fred from Brooklyn. I don't get this one. He's been on hold for well over an hour.
What up, Fred?
Fred, it better be good.
What's up, guys?
Hey.
The back page of the Post today.
Yep.
That's Ben's hug she's talking about, right? I fucked up.
Oh, no, you know what?
Good visual.
She's got her fingers wide apart like she said, I caught a fish this big. And you're saying she's describing Ben's cock. And yeah. You waited an hour to say that.
It's Sassy Sasha.
Sassy Sasha.
Fred thought a visual joke would be great for the radio show. Thank you, Fred.
It's something we do constantly.
Yeah, jokes always good when you have to explain them.
Exactly.
Hey, how do we know every listener that's listening didn't have a New York Post turn to the back page?
Yeah.
Ready for that joke.
You're playing devil's advocate, and I like it.
Certainly. Guzzo.
Hey, morning, guys. Morning, Billy. Happy Wednesday, Jimmy.
Hey, thanks, pal. Godspeed.
Hey, really quick, Jimmy, you did sell out up here in Albany, except for the Friday 8 o'clock show, which I will be at.
Are the other shows sold? I didn't even know that.
The other ones are definitely sold out, yeah.
Fucking me and Dane Cook, man. We're tearing up the country.
That's pretty cool. One show left.
Thanks, buddy.
8 o'clock show Friday for Jim Norton in Albany.
What football stadium is Dane performing in?
Oh, it's awful. He's doing Wembley. Christ. I'm doing Abu Ghraib. He's fucking...
I feel a little jealousy in the room. A little jealousy.
Oh, yeah, a little jealousy. No, you know what? To be
it's
jealousy.
A lot of jealousy.
No,
it's
a little jealousy.
A lot of jealousy.
You know what it is? To be jealous of somebody, they have to still be in your sights. He's so fucking far over the horizon. I'm actually enjoying it.
But I'm not. I'm still jealous. My website fucking has a C prompt on it, and his fucking actual live face pops through your computer and talks to you.
Let's get a mic in New Orleans.
I need help, Mac.
Today, guys, I learned that anal sex has been upgraded from a 2-point conversion to 14 points.
14 points.
14.
Attaboy.
Let's say hi to Rich in Michigan. Rich?
Hey, if you didn't wipe off that excess maxiderm, wouldn't the pussy just get big, too? Punch it out.
Wouldn't the what?
Pussy.
Oh. No, it's not about being big. It's about staying hard.
Ray Pierre.
Hey, how you doing? Hey. I learned some phone numbers today.
Okay.
Hey.
212-584-5120. Mel Karmazon would love to hear from you.
No, don't do that.
Let's go to Vito in St. Louis. Vito.
Hey, man, I think what that fucking amateur earlier meant to say is that a month's supply of Maxiderm might have lasted boss a lifetime.
Ugh. A lifetime. Ugh. Way to bring it home.
Momo.
Yeah, I learned today that if you want to have sex, get it in writing.
Yeah, put it in contract form. Makes
hey,
it much more sexy.
Anthony.
Yes, sir.
If you want to get the interns to stop using your bullhorn, take away their GBDs.
You are doing so well.
I'm sorry.
What is that a sound effect from?
It's from the whammy from Press Your Luck.
Never. No whammy, big money, big money, big money. No whammy, no whammy. And stop! Stop on the whammy! Oh, no.
That's the sound the doctor makes when it's stillborn. Is it a boy or a girl? You smack it.
Boy or girl.
Smack it, stop it. It's dead.
Let's go to Dave. Jesus. What is wrong with you? Dave.
What's up, guys?
What's up, Dave?
Here's what I learned. I learned a new way to cure athlete's foot.
All right.
Shut up, Bernard.
Jesus.
That's how we end today, unfortunately.
It's like chips.